Starfield is finally here. I can't actually believe it. Thank you very much to Bethesda for providing me a key today for early access. It's probably one of the biggest things I'm most excited for to share, especially on this channel here. So it's going to be a very long playthrough. I've absolutely loved previous games. Fallout 4, I played a ton back in the day. I don't think I really did a stream of it or played it even on my YouTube channel or Twitch at all. But at some point I would like to. But anyways, today we're going into Starfield, a game that I've been patiently waiting for quite a while now. So with that said, I don't think we're going to delay this any longer. We're just going to hit new game and go right into this and see how it is. We are playing it on PC, by the way, today. And for those of you watching on YouTube, as always, if you guys enjoyed the stream, leaving a like on it does help out a whole lot. Especially with big games like these, it really does mean a lot to me. But here we go. Bethesda Game Studios presents Starfield. Woo-hoo. Getting like chills. Soul date, May 7th, 2330. Here we go. Argos Distractors, Mining Outpost, Moon of Artera, something like that. Oh boy. I have the game mainly on high settings right now.
Oxygen's good. Just do what you did last time, and you're fine. Follow my one simple rule. Hela, what's my one simple rule?
Listen to Lynn. Boss lady knows best.
Jesus, sensitivity's high.
Listen to me. Mining's just like any other job. Go steady, go safe. Go home with a pocket full of credits at the end of the day.
Yeah, totally. It's just like, I work in the Star Dock. Except, with more cave-ins, lasers, and accidental dismemberment.
Very helpful. Oh. Thank you.
That's comforting.
You're gonna be fine. Your first outing was solid. And, you know, let's be honest, it ain't exactly astrophysics.
That's why I keep him around. Good pep talks.
Yeah. And the fact that I can pinpoint a helium deposit from 300 meters.
Not untrue. A shame we won't find any down here.
Okay.
But the metal deposits alone should pay for our
It's looking
fuel.
Pretty crisp right now.
Hell, after this, we'll have enough jump fuel to bounce from one end of the settled systems to the next.
Hey, more minerals, more money. And so the cycle repeats itself.
Just no more Vlad. Authorized jumps in the house for room space, okay?
Thank you for the sub there on YouTube.
He's just a big baby. There are worse lives. You know, most Dusties don't even make it this far. I have a good feeling about you.
Group hug now or at
Got
the
a good
the
feeling about this, too.
One of these days, Hela, I am going to leave you behind.
Promises, promises.
Here we go. Yo, what's up, Soldier Pat? What's up, Ops? What's up, Reeves? Welcome, welcome, chat. Oh, boy. Taking our first steps. WASD.
How
Beautiful.
Are we on time?
Let me turn the sensitivity down a little bit more. I actually turned it down already, but it's still pretty high, so let's bump these down. It should be good.
A little longer. Grab some samples?
Yeah, I think that's
Always.
Fine there.
But not you. Check on
One small step.
Make sure she eases up on the breach. I don't feel like getting buried alive today.
Roger that.
They're following
Remember, Dusty.
Supervisor Lynn.
Steady and never take that helmet off down here. Oxygen processors don't extend this far.
Yeah, because God forbid we drill on a rock with pretty full atmosphere.
Know what I love about working in Freestyle Collective space? You were wrecked. A job like this in the United Colonies?
Okay. So they're breaking the rock down? It's like there's a ton of materials down here.
Calvert! No! Ah, no, no, no! It's a laser, not a sledgehammer! Ease up! If you got paid per break, you'd be a millionaire. Let's go.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
Damn.
What do we say, Dusty? You make your cut, you get your cut. No exceptions. Come on, pick it up. Troy.
How much effort does it take? You just aim and you pull the trigger, right?
Occasional glimmer, but it's weak.
I guess you have to be accurate with it or something.
No, ma'am. Juice ain't worth
Yo, what's up, Mr. Average? Looks amazing for a game with a huge map. Yeah, I can't wait till we get out and actually see the world too. Like right now, we're just in a little cave, so it's gonna be interesting once we make it out of here. Let me know if the game audio is a little bit too loud too. It's kind of hard for me to tell. For me, it sounds fine, but I'm trying to keep an eye on where it's at.
Grab a cutter and mine what you can. Metal deposits are in that cavern. I'll shout out when I need you.
Get the cutter. All right, let's grab this here. Hold to equip. We got it. Audio is good. So far, so good. Wish I could watch, but I have something to do all night. All good, Mr. Average. I hope you might be jumping into it too.
Anyone else bother?
Okay, we got some items, material added there. Oh my god. Faster than I was expecting to be while running there. Grab this too.
You're ready, boss. Get back up here.
Nice, nice.
We got a few more digs to go before I
return to Supervisor Lin.
It's time. You're with me.
All right, let's follow her. My guy, it's doing the classic thing where your guy wants to run as fast as he can, but I have to, you have to like take a step so that way you can't pass them. Okay. All right, lead the way.
Ella, get the readings.
Yeah, about that.
Is there like a toggle walk?
Not if you consider a spike in gravity readings a problem.
I'll have to check the settings later on.
You don't?
What we're after? It'll read as an anomaly. That's what I was told anyway.
Okay, now you're starting to freak me out.
Relax. It's just another job. Come on.
We're getting close.
Boy.
I think. Yeah, everything is just... Lynn, seriously.
It's dark down
here.
There's
something really effed up about this.
Where is it, Hella?
Through there, I think.
Up okay, there?
You're up. Something goes wrong in there, we'll come get you.
Why would anything
That's
go
always
wrong?
A great way to start. If something goes wrong, we'll come get you. Alright, well, let's get up here. Hold F to turn on your flashlight. Got it. Okay.
Still getting weird gravity readings. I guess that's a good thing. Just keep going.
Jeez, you really can't see outside the light.
Do you see anything?
Like, you can't see in your peripheral vision there for a second. We got some floating rocks here. Let's go ahead and take it. Oh, we have to cut it. Take it now. What the elusive man was that?
Okay, take it easy. You were out cold.
No physical damage. Mentally, the jury's still out.
You know who you are? New recruit for Argos Extractors? Ring any bells? Any of this look familiar?
Here comes the character creator. All right, thank you all for watching. We're going to spend the next 3 hours here. All right, let's see what we got here. So you got... I think there's a... Are we back? Bro, you're kidding me. Are you joking right now? We lost connection there. I think we're back, though. I think we are back. All right, we are back. We are back. Are you? Oh my God. The one time, man. The one time that it's like super important, of course it drops. We good. All right, we good. All right, here we go. Of course, you know what's crazy too? My TikTok chat isn't loading for me. I could see it for like a split second. Let me try refreshing it here. Just to see if this does anything. All right, let's see. There we go. Now it's working. Very good. Okay. It's been a while since you had... Yeah, I know. I don't know why all of a sudden we'd have some issues, but I think we should be good now, hopefully. I'll keep an eye out on it, though. Okay. Anyways, so yeah, there's a total of 40 characters that you can create. Or 40 presets that are set for you to create. All right, let's try this. Also, what's up, Ops? Welcome in, by the way. Who do we want to start with? It's kind of weird. There's like no music playing right now. What is that, Buzz Lightyear? Go Buzz Lightyear here. I don't know who's a... You know what? We might start with number one as the preset. Let's see. Let's go through them again real quick. Like I said, it's just the preset. So, I mean, like, if you really wanted to, you could select one of these and then go straight into the background. But, hey, if we're going to spend as many hours as we're going to in this game, we might as well spend a few minutes and do some customization. Let's see. A lot of options here, that's for sure. What was that one? 33? Okay. Might start out with 35. Or actually, you know what? Maybe 37? I don't know. Let's just start out with one. 37. We'll start out with this. Let's see what we have here. So, body. Ah, lore accurate. Now, we'll probably go with something maybe like... Right. Okay. Jeez. It's a lot of options here. What's the center? Okay, so the center is just like your normal. Let's go a little bit. Yeah, right there. That works. That's fine. Body type 1, body type 2. Okay. That'll work. Walk style 1, walk style 2. Can we zoom in? I think I saw how to zoom in for a second there. Skin tone. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. Okay. Let's go for like 2. That works. Why is the dude a middle linebacker? You know what? I see it. All right. So now we got some. Oh, you got skin tone here again. I see. Oh, so here's the head shapes. And then you can also change it up if you really want to. Let's go. I feel like that's fine. Or. I feel like his nose is like condensed in. I don't know what's like normal. What would be normal size? It's like looking into a mirror. Wait a minute. Hold up. Wait a minute here. I'm just kidding. All right, we'll stick with that. Hair, what do we got here? How many hair options do we have? Oh God, when you scroll, it goes through all of the options. Okay, so you gotta play it safe. Gotta play it safe and just click away. Man bun. We'll probably keep a simple haircut. Yeah, just like that. Something short and not too much to take care of. You know, that's a little too much. Honestly, 14, not bad. I mean, even like the starting one was okay. This guy's got a big forehead, I guess. That's a little bit too much puff. Okay. 5. A little too short. Where's like the comb overs or something? 14 isn't bad. I think 14 and 15 are like okay. Dude, I don't know. Maybe my guy just has like a huge head. I feel like all the hair is like super high up there. Yeah, 14. Might do that. What's 27? That's a little too much. Yeah, let's go to... What was 14 again? Yeah, I think 14. That's fine. That works for me. Hair color. Yeah, some nice blue hair. Now, we'll go with... probably 14 again. This is brown. I think this is like pitch black. Maybe we'll do... Or is that black? Yeah, we might do 14 again. All right, yeah, let's do that. All right, what kind of beards do we got here? Woo! Okay. Baby fit. Now, okay. That looks like Buzz Lightyear right there. I think we're going to go with the beard again. Oh my god. you know what? We might actually stick with whatever one we started with. That 16? I think that's fine. Yeah. I mean... Yeah, 14 is this. We're going to stick with 16. I think that works. Facial hair color, I think we gotta make it match. 14 there, nice. Let's check out eyes here. Oh god. We got a lot of different style eyes. And then I guess the next one is... Looks like you. Alright, what kind of eyes do we want to do here? I feel like I always, every game, I mean, just look at my Baldur's Gate playthrough. I always create the same character. It's always big, slightly bigger guy, basic hair, beard, done. That's it. Every game. But hey, it works. It works. Honestly, I might be keeping his eye color the same. 11? What was 11? I was looking at 11 too. I feel like 11 has one eye a little bit closed and the other eye a little bit bigger. But it's not bad. I mean, how often are we going to actually see our character? I might stick with one. I wish you could kind of like compare the two. Crazy eyes. I feel like I have that a little bit sometimes too. Funny enough. All right, you know what? We'll do 11. That works. One is even. You can do third person. Yeah, you can do third person as well. Yo, what's up, Worrisome? How are you in? I got early access from Bethesda. I actually received the key from them. So shout out once again to Bethesda for providing that. So I was able to get in a little bit early. But I know it is fully dropping for everyone that has early access in just about an hour from now. I think we're going to go, I always go with green eyes, so we're going to go number 4 here. Eyebrows, let's see. You can't do third, yeah, we'll probably check out, we'll go between third person and regular. What kind of eyebrows do we go with? I think we might go with like 5. I don't know. Or 7. Or nothing like too crazy, but nothing like, I don't know. Eyebrows are so, F4 or 5. We can do 5. 4 is like very thin. 5's a little like normal. Yeah, we'll do that. Eyebrow color, we'll make it 14, match the hair. Forehead. Alright, let's see. I usually don't like, I don't really get into the whole shaping, but the preset stuff I'll change up a little bit. That's that way we make it a little bit more unique. I might just go with this one, too. Not like we have a ton. Actually, we kind of do have a ton of options here. Sad no bushy eyebrows. I know, right? Yeah, we'll go with 2. That's fine. Nose. Let's see. I might go with... Okay, never mind. I was going to say 2. Oh my god, those nostrils. Oh man. Alright, we're keeping it 1. 1 works. Ears. Honestly, ears look fine right now too. We'll keep that at 1. Cheeks. That's probably fine. You could give them some Giga Chad dimples or something if you wanted. Let's go a little bit. Sure, we'll change it up just a tiny bit. We'll go 2. Mouth. Let's see what kind of mouths we've got. I feel like his lips are already pretty big. So I was trying to see if there's anything. Okay, not that. I feel like these all just change his expression. Now 1 is fine. So maybe we'll just stick with 1. Yeah, we'll just stick with 1. That works. Yo, what's up, Silent? Did streamers get a copy? Some streamers did. I did actually get a copy early from Bethesda, which is pretty cool. Oh god, you can choose teeth? Oh my god. Imagine you could go full pirate and then and just go full like rotten teeth. Nice. Actually fully immersed jaw, man. Holy crap, we still got a lot to go here. All right, I think I'm almost here or almost ready to go. Jimmy Green Teeth as your character name. Did they only give a copy to you guys 1 hour early? No, so a lot of big streamers. I just got my key. So I got approved a few days ago. I had to like submit a form and request it. But I got mine actually around 6 p.m. And then from there, like people have already been playing it since 12 today. So there's already been people that have been playing since 12 p.m. today, which is 7 hours ago. So yeah, for me, I've literally only been in for the last 25 minutes. So I guess we've been doing some customization here. Jewelry, I think we'll... I mean, I'm not opposed to having some earrings, but just in case you can't change it, I'm just going to go with none. Okay, it looks like this is like skin tone or some like freckles and stuff. Okay, I see. Different like tan lines. I forget what the thing is with the A called. We'll go with 1 maybe. Maybe like, yeah, 1. Keep it basic. Complexion, scars. See what kind of scars they have. Of course, they've got the Geralt, the Harry Potter. Nice. The Joker. Got a good amount of scars here. Damn. Facial forms. What is that? Oh, okay. Oh, it's like, feature. It's like your eyes and other things to add to. Okay, huh. Interesting. You could make a lot older looking character. Ooh, tattoos. All right, here we go. Here we go. Do they have any body tattoos, though? I have no idea. I still... This might take a little bit because I have no idea what I'm doing for my background. I don't know what kind of class I'm playing. I don't know anything that I'm doing yet. I literally just booted up the game and was like, all right, we're going in, creating our character, and we'll figure everything out from there. Yeah, I was watching Ko play earlier today for a while, too. Wait, if we go back to body, yeah, it's kind of a bummer. They don't have any, like, tattoos that you can get. You can only get face tattoos, it looks like. How about neck? Do they have any neck tattoos? Just out of curiosity. Why is it got like way zoomed in now too? Do they have like one little neck tattoo or something that's on the side of his face? Baldur's Gate 4 in outer space. Yo, what's up, Annabelle? Welcome back. This one's kind of cool. I do actually like this. If it didn't have the face portion, I would probably do it. Okay. All right. I think we're good. I would, but I think right now we're good. You could throw it. Wait, hold on. Put some dirt on your face. A lot of these would be great for a pirate playthrough. Like if you're a space pirate, that'd be perfectly fitting. All right, let's see what we have here for backgrounds. Once again, for people watching on YouTube, if you guys enjoy the stream, leaving a like on it does help out a whole lot. Hopefully this series does just as well as Baldur's Gate, because I absolutely love that, and we're still planning on continuing that as well. But anyways, background, here we go. Oh god, there's a lot more. What? There's one called File Not Found. All right, let's get ready to read. Here we go. Beast Hunter, Bouncer, Bounty Hunter, Chef. Oh my god. Michael Bryan, yo! Hello, sir. Welcome. How you doing? Oh boy, we're just getting started here, man. I'm kind of nervous. Yo, thank you for the follow there, man. And that was good timing, because it was That was good sound effect, because Skyrim. Level up. Anyways, thank you, man. Appreciate that. We're going through all these. I don't know if we'll go through all of these, but there are a lot. Though I'll probably look at the ones I'm most interested. So Beast Hunter. Do we go Beastmaster yet again? We've been going Ranger Beastmaster in Baldur's Gate. What does this give you? From the Ashta of Aquila to the Terramorphs that plague the whole of the settled symptoms, hostile alien life abounds. You've learned the skills to track them, find them, and take them down. Interesting. I probably won't read the background every time, only for the ones I'm really interested in. But so, starting skills, fitness, and space. The greatest commodity is oxygen, and increased lung capacity gained by the regular physical fitness regimen is essential to survival. Centuries of conflict have proven when it comes to threat elimination, few things stack up against the reliable power of high-speed projectiles. And gastronomy, access to brand new worlds means access to brand new ingredients. There is also no limit to the delicious foods and drinks a talented chef can prepare. Interesting. Okay. So these are kind of like, you get three starter skills. Can we go Beast Hunter Master once again? Yeah, that'd be interesting. Bouncer does sound pretty cool. Boxing, security, and fitness. Okay, so there are reoccurring ones. Security, while the standardized digital locking mechanism is renowned for its security, any code can be broken with the proper training. That's cool. Bounty Hunter, piloting, targeting control systems, and boost pack training. Number of those certified with effective pilot increases various types of spacecraft has increased dynamically. Missile weapons are favored because they can lock onto enemy ships. And then it looks like you have a boost. Okay. Chef, combat medic, pistol certification, medicine, wellness. Combat medic I would like because you have medicine. Wellness, I think that would be interesting too. Pistol certification, I wouldn't mind that. Cyber Runner is a very interesting one too. Stealth, who values discretion above all else, the ability to approach a target while undetected and kill them with a silenced weapon. Security and theft. Okay. Sounds pretty cool. Cyberneticist. It's like scientist, but cyberneticist. Medicine, security, and lasers. Personal laser weapons are in widespread use in the settled systems, and specialized training can greatly increase their effectiveness. That one I like too. Hey, you know I love my persuasion checks. So, diplomat, persuasion, commerce, and wellness. Okay. That's an option. Explorer, lasers, astrodynamics, surveying, gangster, homesteader, weightlifting. Weight training can significantly increase the ability. Okay, so you can carry more, it looks like. Industrialist, security research methods, long hauler, pilgrim, professor, ronin. Ronin would be sick if I was good, but not for a first playthrough, probably. Dueling, stealth, and scavenging. Bethesda is not really known for being all melee, especially if you're playing on like harder difficulties. It can be a little more challenging, so I think we're going to be going like probably ranged for most of the playthrough. Maybe a little bit stealthy too if I can. Sculptor, medicine, geology, and persuasion. All these classes sound... Yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, these are just starting. I mean, it is your background, right? So I'm assuming there's going to be some options that kind of... like during dialogue, that'll give you something that you can say like, oh, I'm an industrialist, so I know about this thing that we're talking about right now. You know, there's also soldier fitness, ballistics, and boost pack training. Ronin, sculptor, space scoundrel. All right, I have to look. What is file not found? Oddly, there is no information on the file about your past life. Clerical oversight, deletion by some powerful unknown faction, or was there just nothing to mention? Seems legit. Whatever the reason, your past is known only to you. What's important, the here and now, and the path you're about to forge. Wellness, ballistics, and piloting. That's actually a pretty good well-known, pretty good, like, starting out, well-rounded, I feel like. Wellness, ballistics, and piloting. I need to go something with persuasion. I think that's going to be the route. I think I might go diplomat, just because the ability to listen, discuss can oftenly accomplish far more than simply shooting first and asking questions later. Then we also can, we can sell better or get better stuff, buy at a cheaper price. I think diplomat's going to be a good start. The wars are over. Peace now reigns the settled systems, but only because there are those quietly fighting to keep it. Because of you, agreements were signed and words were heeded, lives were spared. I think that's sounds good to me. Let's go ahead and start with diplomat. Okay. One last thing to do. We got to select three traits, or I think we do. I think you can choose up to three traits. When is early access? I thought it's tomorrow. Early access officially starts at 8 p.m. tonight for everyone that has the early access edition. I was provided a key, so that's how I am able to play, and a few other streamers out there. Some streamers have been playing since 12 p.m. today. Other ones got their access at like 6 p.m. like myself. But yeah, it'll be out very, very soon for everyone. Let me check one thing, chat, and we are good. All right, sweet. Just making sure that everything's working still. I don't know what that hiccup was at the beginning of the stream. As long as YouTube is still going too, We should be set. Okay. Yeah, there was just a little hiccup. But, okay. Anyways. Well, all right. We got another not as long list for traits here. I think the one thing with traits is they give you a positive and some of them give you a negative too. So, for example, alien DNA volunteered as a controversial experiment that combines alien and human DNA. As a result, you start with increased health and oxygen, but healing and food items aren't as effective. Dream home. Yeah, you can go on. You own a luxurious, customizable house on a peaceful planet. Unfortunately, it comes with a 125 credit mortgage with Galbank that has to be paid weekly. You get a mortgage and a house. And you know what else? Since I watched a few streams earlier, you can go full on dad. You can go dream house. You can go kid stuff. Your parents are alive and well, and you can visit them at their home. But you will automatically send 2% of your credits home to them every week. And then on top of that, I think you can do, there's one more, I think, that's like family oriented. Empath, let's see. Did you see this? Yeah, I did see Volition, unfortunately, is getting shut down. Yeah, that really sucks, man. But, I mean, Saints, the latest Saints Row, I played it. I thought it was, like, okay, but it wasn't anything, like, crazy. But, yeah, unfortunately, that sucks. But it is what it is, I guess. What is empath? You are deeply connected to the feelings of others. Performing actions your companion likes will result in a temporary increase in combat effectiveness, but performing actions they don't like will have the precise opposite effect. Oh. No, I'm good. What about this? Extrovert. Can't be... Okay, we're not going extrovert, but let's read it anyways. You're a people person. Exerting yourself uses less oxygen when adventuring with human companions, but more when you're adventuring alone. Okay. Free Star Collective Settler. Gain access to Free Star Collective dialogue options and better rewards from some missions given by the faction, but crime bounty towards other factions is greatly increased. Here we go. Hero worshipped. You've earned the attention of an annoying, adoring fan who will show up randomly and jabber at you incessantly. On the plus side, he'll also join your ship's crew and give you gifts. If anything, I think I'm going to do that just because we have chat. Because you guys are coming on along the journey with me, this is going to be the essence of chat. So we're going to bring Hero Worshipped. I feel like that's going to be fitting because you'll never know when they show up. And sometimes when he does, he'll give us some gifts. So, should be interesting. What is introvert? You really need your alone time. Exerting yourself uses less oxygen when you're adventuring alone, but more adventuring with other companions. Okay, I see. Kin stuff, we read that one. Neon Street Rats, gain access to special dialogue options and better rewards from some missions on Neon Crime Bounty. Okay. Raised Enlightened. You grew up in a member of the Enlightened. You gain access to a special chest full of items in the House of the Enlightened in New Atlantis, but lose access to Sanctum Universum chests. Can't be combined with any other religion traits. Let's not do that. Serpent's Embrace. Okay, it looks like these are can't be combined. Space. Your body has become acclimated to space. Health and oxygen are increased when in space, but decreased when on the surface. What is Taskmaster? Occasionally, if you have crew trained in certain ship system, that system will automatically repair itself to full health whenever it's damaged below 50%. However, all crew costs is twice as much. No, thank you. All right, I think we're good. Health and oxygen. United Colony is native. Okay, we're just going to go hero worshipped. A lot of these negatives, I mean, they would be fun if you're going more of a, like, say if we were going cyber something and we went street neon street rat, that would fit out really good. But for today, we're just going to start with Hero Worship and go into this. Avery, thank you for the three roses on TikTok. Okay, here we go. We're going in with this, and our name just going to be Casas. Here we go. Do I hit enter? Confirm. R.
Huh, forgot. Former diplomat, right?
Ah, yes.
You must have said the wrong words to the wrong people to wind up here. Well, you got the sample. Client's on his way. Then we all get paid. You remember anything that happened?
It was incredible. Like a dream or a vision.
Easy there, High Flyer. Probably just the endorphins kicking in when you passed out. Don't go having an experience on me. You'll walk it off. More importantly, we got what we were looking for.
All this trouble for that stupid thing? Sure don't look like much.
Never mind what it looks like. It's worth more than this mine has pulled in all month. We'll be... Speak of the devil.
Use mouse 3 to switch to third person. And third... Oh, and first. Okay, there we go. So that's how you switch. Wow, that's pretty easy. So it's literally middle mouse button.
A constellation.
What? My guy actually... he Wait, does look like a linebacker. I feel like I'm going to go play some football after this.
Kind of a joke.
Not a joke.
All right, coach. Put me in, coach.
Hey, I'm just
put me in. I'm ready.
Well,
let's go play for the space... The space...
Half the crew
Federation college
exists,
football.
But it's still there.
Or I mean, no, yeah, whatever. Anyways, sports
yeah,
joke.
Come on. Exploring
from
space.
Guy that doesn't watch sports.
Does that anymore? Ain't the space we've already got complicated enough?
Not well, to them, apparently.
Supervisor Lynn, okay.
Yes, she would know.
Yeah, we really need to know. Is there like a toggle walk?
All right, Dusty. Airlock. Put your helmet on.
Press tab to open the data menu. Yo, Ilmoje. Ilmoje? Thank you for the sub there on Twitch. Thank you for the sub with Prime. I appreciate that. Also, welcome. Thank you very much there. He looks like the one guy from... What, Dom? Wait, it actually does look a little like Dom. If that's who you're thinking of. I can see that. Select the area in the lower right to access your inventory. Okay, there it is. New items. So we have a jumpsuit. All right, we have so we got the deep mining space helmet. Select helmets category. Where is helmets right here? Boom. Press tab to exit. So this is our apparel underneath here. Does it have any difference? Okay, this one gives you a little bit better. I don't know, not much, but some. So we need our helmet on outside? How much of the game is available in early access? Folks, we have left the vault. That's kind of... That's sick. That music cue there was really good. So the full game is available in early access. It's really just access to the game earlier than the full release, aka another way to make more money. But for a game like this, I think it's kind of worth it, in my opinion. I mean, if I wasn't provided a key today, I would have just purchased it myself. But somehow, some way, I actually was approved. So, shout out again to Bethesda for providing that. But yeah, I. All right, that was pretty sick seeing that thing land. What are we getting frame rate wise right now? Okay, so I'm running mainly high settings. I definitely noticed the game dropping a little bit So as of right now, I'm getting 50 frames-ish. Let's see if I turn on DSR. Now, I haven't really messed with some of the settings. Oh, volumetric lighting, we can bump that down. Oh, some of the things are ultra. I thought I was on high for everything. Oh, yeah, it is on ultra. Let's try turning on FSR 2.0 or 2. I saw some people with FSR on anyways, and it seemed to work pretty good. So let's give this a shot. I think that was worth.
Yes, it has.
That
mine on Bendy, right?
It's about 60, like 58, 60. Might have to mess around with the now, settings a bit.
So, you found something?
Right here. The new guy found it.
That right. And everything went cool? Just like grabbing those minerals on Bendy?
Kazal. And no
so we got Barrett and Supervisor Lynn. Oh, wait.
Woke up saying all kinds of nonsense.
Vasco.
Is that right, cowboy? Oh. Went on a trip, huh?
You could call it that.
That fun, huh? Not the most gentle push into the great mysteries of space, but hey, been there.
Look, just hand over the credits, and I'll be happy to never see this thing, or you ever again.
That's why I like you, Lynn. All business.
I still feel like my sensitivity is really high right now. Reporting a ship coming in
hot from orbit. I really thought I lost them.
Hold off the pirates. Oh, here we go. Do we even have a gun? Grab a weapon. Where's the weapons at? Right here. How is that optional? What if you, what? Do you do a pacifist run? Oh god. Get in cover! Do I need to swap my weapon? Weapons? Eon. We got pirates coming out. All right, there's one hit. Okay, this thing is not great. I feel like I still need to mess with my sensitivity. It'll take a second to get used to. It's right there. They're really taking some hits right now. Your health is low. Use a med pack by pressing 0. You can also equip med packs by going to your inventory. Wait, is that O or 0? I'm pressing 0. Oh, okay. That is a weird keybind. Oh, that's a friendly. I almost feel like there's mouse acceleration or something. Let's see. I'm going to go back to interface for a second or controls here. Let's bump this all the way down. Oh, you know what I was doing? I was bumping down look sensitivity. Not aim sensitivity. Here we go. Mouse look sensitivity, that's another option too. All right, let's try this. Still feels pretty fast. Aiming down sights feels better though. Okay, let's talk to Barrett.
Now that was some fine work under pressure. You dug up the artifact, right? That means
sure.
You saw it. The visions. You're coming with me to Constellation. You're part of this now.
If they can tell me what this artifact is of yours is, then I'm in.
Marvelous.
Oh no, Barrett. take off after the mess you caused?
Oh, right. I guess I did just put you all on the Crimson Fleet hit list. How about I stay and I send your Dusty here in my place? I know, but he's not some miner anymore, Lynn. Soon as he touched that rock, something changed. Don't tell me you can't feel it.
Fine. It's a deal. Get out of here, Dusty. You're on to bigger things.
Hey. Well, not my job. No, I'll take anything other than being stuck here just mining stuff. Thanks for everything, Lynn.
Just go. Before I say something I regret.
Well, now that that's settled. Vasco, get him to the lodge. No deviations unless absolutely necessary, okay? Protocol Indigo.
Sounds good, Indigo. SPC. Thanks for stopping by.
Again. Very well.
Indigo again.
Hey, take this.
Is the game any good so far? We're very early on, but I'm definitely interested in seeing where it goes. Got a watch. Ah, a chrono mark. Nice.
Hey, look at that. The watch fits you perfectly. Now, questions?
What kind of questions? Why was the Crimson Fleet after you?
They're just following the loot, like pirates do. And I have something of a reputation as a loot collector.
You sure it's not anything else? What exactly did we dig up?
That, my friend, is the million credit question. And Constellation can find the answer with your help.
Okay. Alright, let's just... Wait, who are you and what's Constellation? Constellation.
See, that's the problem with the settled systems. Too easy to take everything for granted. While everyone else is busy playing politics, we're the ones braving the unknown, charting the vastness of space. Without us, the galaxy is just a big room with the lights turned out.
Okay. All right, yeah, we'll just get on.
Don't let him break my ship.
Board the ship. Yeah, we're very early on still. I've only really done character customization, fought our first combat scenario, and now we're getting into the ship. But we have been live for about an hour now, with character customization taking us the longest. Oh, there's another med pack here. Nice. Pharmaceutical, or wait, what's that? Pharmaceutical kit. Interesting. Let's board the Frontier.
Captain, I assume you know how to fly a
take
class
off from Bectera.
As Barrett likes to say, it's as easy as
we've got our first ship.
I will attempt to boost the shield just in case there are any difficulties.
Oh man, wait. Oh, he just left a sandwich here? Digipack. That looks like a lightsaber like handle. I'll take that sandwich, don't mind me. Chunks of an apple. Impact driver. That sounds like the Fallout computers. Eat it, eat the sandwich. Oh, we will. Don't worry, we will. I feel like I still need to bump down my sensitivity. Do not use broken Constellation space helmet. What else is here? We got tons of pictures of, what was his name? Vasco? Something like that. A pot. Open container. Grinder coffee bag. Red harvest white. Some more coffee, I guess. Lunar robotics. Accept no limitations. Please wash your hands before starting work. A chunks cap. Hydraulic clamp. Okay. All right, let's open this up. Yeah, half-eaten germs all over it. Jump seat. Coffee mug. Ooh. All right, this is looking pretty cozy. Let's get into our pilot seat. Here we go.
Shields ready. The rest is up to you.
Press hold space to take off. Here we go. man, and there's the achievement. All for all into the Starfield. Okay. Now that we're in space,
now that we are in orbit,
where are we headed?
Wise to test all controls and systems to ensure they are not on the verge of catastrophic failure.
Okay.
I can step you through the entire process, or if you're
yes,
already
please
an
do.
Experienced
no,
pilot,
no, no, no.
Just power up all the systems.
Show me the process. Show me the process. Hold left alt and use WASD to switch between systems and allocate power. You can skip the ship guidance tutorial by powering up all systems, including the Gearav drive. Okay. Hold left alt and WASD. Okay, I see. So we have laser balance. Okay.
Each system on a ship requires power. Allocating power is under your direct control. Let's go over the engines.
Sure.
Control our maximum speed. Try increasing and decreasing our relative velocity.
Okay. That's how you... Okay, so we have a total of 14 right now.
A ship's engine has a sweet spot for better handling during turns. Draw your attention to the HUD. You'll notice a speed indicator in the lower left.
Yep, I see it.
That goes up and down.
How fast can we go?
The throttle. Try to center the gauge so that it lines up with the center of the vertical bars to its right.
Line up the gauge so it lands with the vertical bars to the right.
Boosts can be engaged for temporary bursts of speed.
Okay. Let's hit boost. Nice. All right. There goes all of our boost.
Let's turn our attention to the shields. Try adjusting power to the shields. Notice more power increases.
All right,
their
let's
strength.
Move power to the shield. So if we take it
from damage without a hull, but be vaporized. Shield health is displayed in the lower right. Hull damage is below it.
Okay, I see. So we take all SHD is shield. Shield's offline, got it. So we can only have three in there right now.
You've proven an adequate pilot.
Got it.
Familiar with ship combat tactics,
oh!
Because that's a Crimson Fleet ship bringing its weapons.
Time
to
get into combat.
We will need to disable their shields. Laser-based weaponry is particularly effective.
Press mouse 1 to fire the Gatling laser.
If you can keep the enemy ship
almost got it.
HUD, we can lock in to fire a homing missile. The enemy shields are down, Captain.
Press G to fire a missile. Up, we got it.
The hull once shields are offline.
Got it. Okay, so mouse 2 is ballistic cannon.
Congratulations on surviving.
And then G is missile. Oh god, oh jeez.
We should search the wreckage
this
for
fine.
Spare parts and other salvage. You will need to fly close to it before we can access the remains.
Okay. What do I do? Fly close to the shipwreck and press E to loot them. Oh. Let's take it all. We got some credits from that. Our first ship defeated. Look at that. I feel like this is actually a pretty, like, solid starting ship, too. Like, it feels cozy.
Two more Crimson Fleet ships are
Press E to cycle between targets.
Captain.
Oh, boy. Is it good so far? It seems pretty cool. I'm pretty early on. I mean, I'm only about an hour in after customizing my character, but I'm enjoying it. Let's try going over to this guy. Oh man, enemy missile locked in. He's out of shields, I think. Got him. Flipping it around. Come on. I see you. I feel like we're both doing the same. All right, let's slow it down. Here we go. Here we go. Get those shields down. Fire the rockets. locking on. Locked. Fire. There it is.
Anticipated. At this rate, the odds of continual assault from their ships are high enough to jeopardize our mission. In short, they are after the frontier and will not stop.
Let's try to loot this if I can.
Crimson Fleet Captain.
Yo, what's up, Oshak?
Indicates an abandoned facility on the nearby moon.
Well, let's see.
A perfect staging area for pirates.
Press tab to open data menu. From there, you can open the star map. All right, we'll do that in a second. Let me see if I can... where'd that other ship go? How are you already able to play? So I was provided a key from Bethesda, so I was able to get a little bit early access. I know some other streamers have been playing way longer today, but that's how I'm playing a little bit early. But it's almost out. It's out in like 10 minutes, right? For everyone. So, almost there. Is it dope? It feels pretty good so far. I'm really excited to see once we get to our planet. Let's loot this one too, real quick. Jeez. Oh my god. Trying to slow down. So excited to get the Constellation Edition in the mail. That sounds sick. Trying to get this. It's not as easy as it looks, chat. I'm like floating around in space. Trying to break. Alright, there we go. Alright, so to the star map. Which one? Top left. So top left is star map, bottom left is ship, missions, items, and skills. Okay. Travel between the stars. Zoom out to see the entire star system. Zoom out again to see all the stars in the settled systems. Plot a course by selecting the star system you want to travel to. Your ship can only jump so many light years at once, so distant star systems may require you to jump to a closer star first. All right, so that's where we came from. Vectera. I see. So how do we zoom out? And then you can view resources here. Back to system. So here's the entire system. We need to travel to Crete, I think. So if I click on this one, or zoom onto it, set course. Oh, you can just press and hold X. There we go. Yo, what's up, Adrian? Also, what's up, Bree? Hey, all right, I'm doing pretty good. I'm doing good. Reminds me of Warframe with the system travel. I can see that.
Our Crimson Fleet captain is on the surface.
I haven't played Warframe in a very long time, but I've wanted to go back because of all their the stuff they've had added for the story-wise and other things. Let's, I'm gonna drop my shield and put it into engine. Let's see how this goes. Press tab to open the data menu. From there, you can open the star map again. The planet view of the star map gives you information about the environment, lets you scan the planet for resources, and helps you discover key landing sites. Rotate the map until, or the planet until you see the Crete Research Lab map icon in its view, then select the map icon to land there. So, okay, I see. We can also scan it. Let's go ahead and scan the planet. Oh, that's pretty cool. Very strong. Type is rock. Gravity is 0.55 Gs. Temperature, atmosphere, magnetosphere is very strong. Resources, okay. Water, helium, iron, lead, argon, alkanes, silver, and neon. All right, so we're gonna set a plot for here. Set landing target. And land. Oh, I think that's the fast travel. I think you can set a target and then fly towards it and then actually it'll start landing. Corey can do this.
I'll follow you from here on out, Captain.
Here we are. Deal with the Crimson Fleet Captain. Exit ship. Let's go ahead and get out. Oh, you can also press and hold E. Okay, that's cool. So from the cockpit, you can press and hold E to get up. You can do X to just completely get off the ship, or you can,
Captain,
yeah, get out your seat
Indigo
and then get off the ship.
Dictates that I am to return to the lodge with no deviations. We are here to stop the Crimson Fleet from pursuit. Nothing more.
Okay. Just who are you and Barrett? What's the Constellation?
Constellation is an explorer's society founded over 50 years ago with the mission of seeking out the unknown. Members often engage in expeditions in small groups, typically one or two people, or like Barrett and myself, one person and one robot. The membership is intentionally limited and small. Should you join Constellation yourself, you will be the 10th active member.
Okay. All right, let's get to moving. Here we are.
According to the scanners, the abandoned research facility is in this direction.
All right, let's go check it out. What the hell is that? So anyways, I started blasting. Eat the rock. Ooh. Can jump around? I don't know whether I'm gonna stick with like third person or if I'll go to. I almost felt like I could aim a little bit better. Oh, Jesus. What the? Reload. Wait, I didn't check to see if these had anything. All right, that's satisfying. Jumping in the air like that. How's the game so far? Well, we just got onto our first planet besides the starting one. So far, it feels pretty good. The game seems to be running fine for me. We're pretty much getting it. We're on high settings. And we're getting about 60 frames-ish on PC. It says it's a little bit lower, but it honestly feels like it's higher. So I don't know if that's just the performance overlay for this, or let me check what Steam says. I'm curious if Steam shows the same one. Where is performance on Steam, actually? Interface. In game. Oh, here we go. Maybe in game. 2 minutes. Almost time for you guys. It's going to be interesting. See, here we go. Let's go top left. Okay. Yeah, so we're getting about that. About 60. I could still bump my settings down. But that's okay. The Crete Research Lab. What is this stuff? So if you press F, that's how you can scan. Scan creatures, minerals, and plants. Each unique item scan progresses your survey data of the planet. Completed survey data can be sold for credits. Scanner mode also unlocks additional features such as building outposts and using social skills lines like diplomacy and intimidation. Nice. Okay, so how do we actually scan it? Do we just look at it? Photo mode, I see that. We try moving into first person. The game is officially out in 1 minute for everyone. And how am I playing a little bit early? I've been, I was provided a key from Bethesda for streaming it a little bit early, so that's how I was able to get it. Along with many other streamers that were able to get into it. So it says press E, but I guess we're not actually... Oh, okay, it highlights stuff. I see. Now I understand. Can I shoot it? I'm assuming you have to use the other tool. Can you select keybinds for these? Like if I go... Or do I have to actually swap to it in order to do that? Not bad. All right. So that's how that works. What else can we scan here? Scan resource. We can see some footsteps over there. Interesting. Survey 56%. So we need to find fauna, flora, and resources in order to get 100%. Let's see. Before we go inside, let's actually try. Show resources. Iron added. How do you get the diamond pickaxe? Well, you see, you gotta go find Barret, and then from there you can make a portal to the Elder Space Gods, and then from there, once you defeat the primordial one, you can actually get the axe. What is crafting light? I don't know yet. We haven't gotten to that. We haven't gotten the tutorial for crafting yet. I'm kind of just seeing what we can find. We just landed on our first planet here, so let's try scanning this. I like how it starts to highlight things that you can. Oh, my bad. Dust root, 13% scanned. Oh wait, do you have to actually like scan the entire thing? Interesting. Yeah, I could be going right into the building right now, but I'm just checking this real quick. So I think items turn green when you scan them. No way there's something all the way out there. Unknown? Unknown. Structure? Ship. Okay. Oh, there's a bunch of stuff over there. Yo, what's up, Tank? How are you enjoying the game? It's pretty cool so far. I'm most interested in seeing like where the stories go and the NPCs that you meet and all of that. But so far it looks pretty cool. So Crete graze. Oh god, they're about to. Whoops. Can you not have keybinds to change this? Oh, nice. Oh, wow. This thing actually does damage. Sweet. Oh, my God. Wait, who knew it would be actually good? What the hell? Take a picture. Hurry. Yeah, somebody take a pic. All right, let's try scanning again. I do want to go, but I'm getting lost. I'm getting sidetracked, guys. Sorry, the ADHD is kicking in right now. What is down there? Is the game bad? I would say no. Personally, I think the game is going to be, like, I mean, I'm what, an hour and 16 minutes into the game? So I can't really say whether, oh my god, this is going to be the craziest game ever, or no, oh my god, it's terrible. I mean, personally, I liked Fallout 4. I liked narrative-driven games. So something like this is definitely more up my alley than, you know, like a survival space game. I've played Elite Dangerous. I've played No Man's Sky. I've played even a little bit of Star Citizen, and they're all good in their own areas too. Star Citizen, probably the most realistic simulator. Meanwhile, No Man's Sky is probably one of the more like casual simulators in a way. But it's also very complex at times. This game, obviously it's in space, but it's gonna be more story driven, and then you also have the survival aspect. But like I said, every single space game in one way or another is going to cater to one type of player more than another. So, me being like a big RPG fan, hopefully this game delivers on story, on role playing, on all of that. So we'll see. But regardless, I mean, from what I've seen so far, it seems pretty cool. I'm definitely interested in it. Gives me Mass Effect. That's another thing. It does, there's parts of it where it really does give me, like, almost a advanced or new Mass Effect style game. All right, I don't think we need to 100% this planet here. So let's go back to the fleet captain. What is that? My guy, like, struggling right now? Yeah, that's the other thing, too, is, I mean, I could wait until Game Pass. Like I said earlier, if I wasn't provided a key or if I bought the game myself, which I was going to anyways, I could just have waited until it came to Game Pass in 5 days, 6 days. And that in itself is like an insane deal, because you spend what, like $15, you don't like it, okay, you play something out of the 500 other games on Game Pass, or you just go on to another game. But am I the only one who can't play the game? I have seen a few people in chat say they haven't been able to get in so far. I don't even have an Xbox. I'm going to cloud play it through my Steam Deck. Yeah, that is an awesome thing, too. Like, being able to just play it on Steam Deck. Now, I don't know how well it's going to run on Steam Deck, but even with that option, it's still pretty cool, you know? Keeps telling me I'm too early. Yeah, I would check probably Xbox's Twitter or something. They might have like an update or something talking about it. But are there elemental storms? Not sure, to be honest. I mean, I'm only an hour and 15 minutes in, so we're still on the very early side of things. Let's swap back to the pistol here. Actually, oh, here you go. So this is how you can favorite items. Okay, so one, well, there you go. I didn't realize why or how you can swap between weapons. You have to favorite them to your slot. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then it looks like you have left right brackets. Damn, yeah, lots of people complaining on Twitter. Yeah, that's what I'm sure it sounds like. A lot of people can't get in, so I totally get that. Totally get that. Alright, let's pull the pistol out.
Curious. The These are United Colonies markings, but we are in Freestar Collective space. It then stands to reason that this was once a secret UC facility.
What's the whole premise of a game? Of the game? Fallout in space. Pretty much. Honestly, that's really the best way you can explain it. Fallout in space with more survival stuff, more base building, ship building, and stuff like that. I mean, that's really, really it. Genetic sample bottle. I'm checking to see what's in here. See some combat. Well, we're chasing after the fleet leader or something here, so I'm assuming we're probably gonna find him soon, or them. Oh, well, there's a body. Credits, notebook, notepad, storage box. Wait, can we actually scan like this? Okay. I wish there was like something you could press that would highlight the whole area that you're in, so it'd be a little bit easier to see items. Pick up digipicks and the credit thing. Is that the stuff that I just found in this box here, or is that something else? History of xenobiology. Portable desk fan. Spoon, ratchet. It was downstairs. Oh, okay. I'll go back down. Yeah, I'm hearing, I see you guys on TikTok. I'm hearing that there's some issues right now. Hopefully they get it resolved. I mean, I'm on PC. I don't know if there's anything, if it's only Xbox specifically. But like I said, check Twitter. Oh, here we go. Digipack. And I guess that thing. Oh, that's credits. Credits should do fine. There's a syringe. They pushed the release back another 3 weeks. No! Folder here. By the way, we're also live on Twitch, which is Casas Plays TV, and YouTube and Kick is just Casas Plays if you guys do want to see the full screen. And I read all chats either way. Alright, let's open up this door here. Yeah, Xbox won't let it start. Yeah. Hey, trust me. I've been there plenty of times where PC had to wait for the Steam to update. So I totally get it. I totally get it. Drink pack beer. Nelly Rart, thank you for the follow there on Twitch. I hear some pirates chatting in here. All right, so F5, quick save there.
Opening fire!
All right, I might need to bump my sensitivity back up again for aiming specifically. Oh God. Oh my God! I'm out of ammo. Honestly, the mining thing wouldn't be terrible. There we go. Rescue axe, fire extinguisher. Yeah, I need to check my sensitivity because something is up with this. It's still like way too high. Let's go controls here. If everything like turned down though. Outpost item rotation speed. Aim sensitivity. I think aim sensitivity is specifically... Let me try bumping these down. Looking controls via the mouse while aiming. Let's put this at like 15. This at 15. No multiplayer? No, this game is pretty much strictly single player. Any good? So far, it's decent. I'm enjoying it. We'll see where it goes, but I'm most interested in seeing how the story plays out and the companions you meet, building your ship, all that good stuff. All right, let's try 10%. I think that's more manageable. Swap to the pistol again. There we go. I think that's a lot better. Let's try this. My dad works at Xbox. He's fixing it. Nice. Hey, thank you for the follow there. Or, yo, thank you guys for the follows on TikTok. Looks like we hit the first goal. Appreciate that. Alright, what else we got in here? So we gotta keep an eye out for credits and stuff. Deck of cards, playing cards, jack of spades. Some dumbbells. Levitating desk. So space Fallout. That is the easiest way to explain it. If you like Fallout and you like space games, you'll probably end up liking this. Starware. What do we got here? New beginnings. Just gonna open everything, see if anything unlocks. Any quests? Notepad. Another digipack. So I guess digipacks are good. Solar Frontiers board game. Smoked salmon filet foam cup. Just picking up everything up. Had to uninstall and reinstall just to play. Really? Hey, if you haven't already, I know there's probably people that haven't done it, but hey, maybe turning it off and turning it back on might do the trick. You never know. That's a classic. UC battle meal. How is it? It's pretty good so far. I've enjoyed it. Got some bandages here. I'm just doing a little bit of looting before we... oh, nice. We found an SMG. Another battle meal. What is that? Can I open this? Chunks of beef. Good. Good, good, good. All right, check this weapon here. Is it endless finding new stuff? Well, all right, here's a quick view of, there's first person combat and third person. Here's a quick view of the planet system I'm in right now. Now, if we go back further, here's the galaxy. Now, we haven't really looked at this yet, but you can already tell there's named ones here. Level 40. Level 15. This one's level 1. So each one of these little dots here are their own galaxies. Can you fly into the sun? I don't see the sun. You might be able to. Maybe. Oh, God. But I don't know. Probably not. And as of right now, the game is not multiplayer. Who knows, though, with PC mods, I would expect there's probably going to be a multiplayer mod at some point. Because you know how modders get down. They're always adding new things. So, all right, we got the new weapon that I wanted to add or check out. Systems, not galaxies. That's right. We're looking at one galaxy, not multiple galaxies. So we got the Exterminator Kraken, which looks like it's a little bit better. Does it take the same ammo type? So it's physical. Mass. Okay, this one takes 6.5 millimeter. 6.5 millimeter. All right, let's put that there. And then we also got this thing, which I'll set to for rescue axe. You know what? We'll set it. We'll do 6. All right, there's pistol. There's that. Does middle side mouse buttons don't do anything? Let me check controls here. How are graphics? Graphics look fine. I have my game mostly on high settings, and I'm getting about 60 frames on PC. I have a 3080 Ti for reference too, but I should bump down some other settings, and I might. Some things are set to ultra, some are high, and I think the only thing I turned to medium was like some other stuff, like volumetric lighting. So let's check controls again, or no, keybinds. That's what I need. Does game have dismemberment? That is actually a good question. That I am not sure. Toggle always run, hold to run. Quick save. Hold on, I'm looking for the circle or zero. Where is... Oh, here it is. I'm trying to set this to my... Yeah, number 10. My mouse, so that way I can heal. And is there a melee keybind? Like something where you just press it and you do some melee attacks? Okay, there is. V. All right, I'm going to set this to V then. Oh, whoops. We go back. Yes. We're going to set... No. Defaults again. It keeps wanting to... Bro. Here we go. Jeez. Mouse 4. And then we're going to do... Heals. No. Well, you know what? That's fine. Let's quick save. There is no dismemberment. Oh, really? Where did that guy come from? We already got guys dropping from the sky. Nice. Okay. Oh my god. We gotta reload. Heal.
In combat, there's a high likelihood of human death.
I hear a guy to the right. Shadow settings low gives better frames. I'll have to mess with that a little bit.
There is nothing nearby.
Okay. Oh god. All right, not bad. I mean, for somebody who's played a turn-based game for the last, like, 3 weeks, getting back and adjusting to a game with first-person shooter is taking a second, but each combat scenario, I'm feeling a little bit better there. Got a pistol down here. A lot of dead scientists here. Excited for the story. I know it'll be 100% better when mods get a hold of the game. Yeah, I mean that too. The possibilities with mods is pretty much endless with what people will be able to do for this game. So I mean, I haven't really played. It's crazy because when Fallout 4 came out and when Fallout 3 came out, at the time I was on Xbox. So playing those games on PC, like when I did eventually switch to PC, was completely night and day. So I never really messed around with a lot of mods and things like that. But nowadays, the amount of things that can be added into games is just, it's insane. So if it's not here now, I bet you there's somebody already thinking, okay, how do I examine the files? How do I get this added in? Like, what do I gotta do? You know, after spending some time experiencing it. So, honest opinion so far, to compare it, it's literally Fallout in space. The story, we haven't really got too far so far at the moment. We're still very early on. I'm only about an hour and 30 minutes into the game. So we've had one quest, which is pretty much come here and stop the leader of these pirates. And then after that, who knows what our quest is going to be next. CNAB, thanks for the follow there on Twitch. Supposedly, if you have the game now, you should be able to play it on Xbox. But it sounds like they're having some issues. I don't know if anybody was able to actually get in. The Bashing Maelstrom. Let's swap this out, actually. Can you mark something for sale? That would be kind of cool. The laser rifle, okay, there's that. Trying to make sure I don't use items that use the same ammo, but at the same time, I want to equip as many things as I can. Let's go. Damn. Alright, so what are my weapons? One. Right now, that's fine. It shows you how much ammo you have, too. 166. So both this SMG and the pistol use the same ammo. I'm actually going to use the SMG instead and put that right here. The Eon. Did I unfavorite it then? Oh, the Eon is right there. Okay, never mind. Looking at different pistols. So the Grendel and the Eon use the same too. So let me move. There's got to be other ways to do this. Grendel, I'm going to move that to one. Grendel does 3 damage. Bashing Maelstrom does 4, but has higher. Everyone is freaking out. Yeah, Annabelle, it's going to be a little bit crazy. Some people it's working, some people it's not. Some people it is. I feel like that's kind of how tonight is going to go. Which, by the way, for those of you guys that want to see the full screen, we're also on Twitch, which is Casas Plays TV. And then YouTube and Kick are just Casas Plays. Pharmaceutical Lab. What is this? Oh, here we go. So here is how you can craft. Bandages, penicillin, snake oil. Let's make some bandages. You can make a total of 7. Sure. Huh. It's actually the same sound effect as using a computer in Fallout, which is funny too. Being able to scan is pretty nice, so it highlights items. Just wondered, how does aiming movement feel? Smooth like Call of Duty Destiny? Is there still... It's not as smooth as Call of Duty and Destiny, but it is smoother than Fallout 4, in my opinion. It's definitely a step up, without a doubt. It's not as clunky as those are.
I'm on it. No one's getting through.
I'm trying to get the aiming down a little bit better. And get sensitivity down. I think that's my hardest part so far.
You know.
Let's open up this door. So you can't have your scanner out and toxin, okay. You cannot have your scanner out and the weapon out at the same time. Do you have VATS in Starfield? There is VATS. I have not, I mean, I think we're a little bit too early on, but they did showcase a VATS-like system in one of their trailers a while ago. Yeah, I heard Xbox is still having some issues trying to connect. Turn it off and back on, or just wait until they get it working. I totally get it though. Trust me, I've been there too on PC when they said something would be released and then it wasn't. Yeah, it's pretty much Fallout in space. Modern day Fallout, or well, future Fallout in space. Ammo case. Can I open this? Ah, okay. So a digipick is a lockpick. Now I see. Yo, what's up, Bells? All right, I moved to YouTube, TikTok, driving me crazy. All good. All good. Fill in all open slots in the layer. Okay, fill in all open slots in every layer to open the lock. Select the key and rotate it until the lines fill up with the gaps in the security layer. Slot the key to fill the gaps. Each item can only be used once. So, like this? Oh. Wait, does it have to... But it won't go in right there. Oh, I see. So, slot key. Slot key. Aha. It's like a putt. Okay, I see. So, you just got to put it together and boom. Certain console commands will disable achievements. Oh, I didn't mean to press that. Okay, not bad. Not bad.
I'm detecting a safe nearby. We could make use of whatever is inside.
Unlock it. Oh! What the hell is that? Can I... So after we kill it, can we still scan it or no? I guess not. That's a pretty cool lockpick system. Yeah, it's nice because it's not like... It doesn't feel...
You're dead. We're all dead.
Super,
relay has been trashed. The
time
is
restrictive,
trashed.
I guess?
We can't call for help.
One in the Nerf gun.
There are more roaring somewhere. And more people screaming.
Not the Illithid tadpole. No! Oh, so that is one. Oh. I thought we were looking at a computer. We're looking at like a data pad there. What's the terramorph? Make it a pet. All right, so you just gotta line up the two holes and slide it in. Once the two holes line up, then you're good, like that. So see, there's an opening here, there's an opening there, boom. This one's probably gonna be... Oh, okay. I don't think that's gonna work. You can undo, though. And he has 6 chances to undo. Maybe I might have done that wrong. Oh, wait. I see. Oh, God. Okay, this is more complex, sir, than I thought. Oh, okay, okay, I see. So we have 5 right here. So this one works. Then we can do this. Or this one. Oh, man, you have to look at the inner one. Oh, God. It's more complex than I thought. Oh, no. That won't work. That won't work either. Jeez. All right, we gotta undo. So I think it has to be something more like this, maybe? Yep. 2. Will this fit? Yep. Whew, okay, that is, all right, so I was overestimating it the first time, but at least you have a few options to undo. Okay. Let's try going up to the roof. That's what she said. It don't get any easier. Yeah, I'm not expecting it to. It's only gonna go up from here. The next thing you know, we're gonna do like that one had 5 layers. Next time we're probably gonna have one that's like 8 to like 20 or something wild. Oh. Quick save. Let's go talk to these guys.
Me. The Frontier has a new captain? You working with Barrett, or did you pry the ship keys out of his cold, dead hands?
Ooh. What's your problem with Barrett anyway?
We don't have a problem with Barrett. We want that ship, the Frontier. If you're the captain of it now, that means we're after you.
Yeah? Well, I'm with Constellation. You need to stop attacking our ship.
Oh, no. You see, maybe your colleague Barrett didn't tell you, but there's a bit of a legend surrounding that ship. That Constellation keeps treasure hidden in the cargo bays, the loot from 100 planets, and it's going to be ours.
That statement is partially correct. The Frontier has been to many planets and moons, but the only things held in the cargo bays are spare parts, dust, desiccated food particles, and a variety of species of ant.
I don't care the game's pretty cool so far. Spirit programmed that robot to say, we're taking that ship.
Whoa, 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 whoa. All right. Time to kick in the diplomat here. There's no treasure in my ship. Cut your losses before more people get hurt.
You're not talking us out of this score.
To persuade a person, you need to make successful choices. Choices can range from kind words to distractions to threats. Each choice has a difficulty. The higher difficulty, the greater the chance this choice fails, but the more points you'll earn when you succeed. You have a limited number of choices you can make, but you can never fail if your last choice succeeds. Okay. Interesting. So the highest one. So we have 3 turns. But this, okay. If we say the highest one, it gives them +3. But if it fails, then it's GG. So does it make sense to just go for the highest one always? I'm gonna try 3. Oh wait, you know what? Wait, that would be trade ships. You know what? Let's say it. Hey, if you want to trade ships, that sounds good to me. The frontier creaks when it turns anyway.
You willing to give up the ship? Just like that?
Oh, there's an auto persuade? Option two. Okay. Oh boy. So now that we have that full... Just take it. Wait, okay. So we need one more. If we go over it, though, do we fail? You have it wrong. Constellation is an explorer's group. They aren't treasure hunters.
They aren't? You sure? Can't believe this. There isn't any treasure. We've been trailing that old Constellation ship for nothing. Get out of here. Take your robot and your ship and get out of here. I see you all again, you're dead.
Speech 100. Nice.
Free to travel to
fast travel to your ship, press F. Oh, that's awesome. Wait, so you can just straight up fast travel to it from here? I can just look at my ship and be like, alright, take me there. Take me home. look for the icon and just press fast travel. Oh, dude, that's sick. Now kill them. No. We'll be the nice guys first. I will loot a little bit more though. We'll see what else we got here. Sean, thank you for the sub there on YouTube. Thank you. We could also just go back to the ship. It looks like there's a few structures here on the planet. Like there's a mining outpost there or something. Can we zoom on this? Yeah, I wish you could bring out binoculars and look through them. So there's a structure over there. I saw on the map that there was a ship somewhere. Yeah, over there, there's a ship. What else? There's a ship 757 meters away. Now, I'm curious... I wonder if you have to run all the way over there, or if you can just, like, can I take off in my ship and then, I know you can't fly around on the planet, I don't think, but, huh. I kind of would go check out that ship, though. Oh, God. Wait, is there damage? We jump from up here. Rogan, pirate. How's everyone playing? So this week, today is early access release, but in next week, September 6th is the release for everyone. So the game will no longer be in early access then. All right, let's try. Oh. Oh, you can do this with your weapon. I don't know why, for some reason I thought you couldn't. You know who I miss already, Cass? Asterion. Me too. I do miss them. Don't worry, we'll be playing plenty of it still. This weekend, we will still be playing tons. Do not worry. Oh, that's water over there? Kill it! Sean, thank you for the sub there on YouTube as well. I think we leveled up too, and I haven't checked that yet. Oh my God! Where'd it go? I think it just got launched. So if something is blue, that means you already... Wait, does that mean you scanned it? No. Scanned. Okay, so it has to be like highlighted blue. And then minerals you scan one time. It's kind of hard to see. I think that's the one that just got launched. Why do they just wobble around? I think it's just Bethesda. Bethesda style game causes the wobbleness. Alright, so there's a ship still over there. There's also unknown. I'm gonna try getting to that. How's the loading times? Loading times have been fine for me. I mean, I've literally only loaded once so far, and it was like under 30 seconds. But I'm also on PC, so I don't know if that adds to it. Really wants me to go back to my ship. We're gonna go find this ship out here though and see what happens. We're only 500 meters out from it. Yeah, so far I like it. I haven't really done a ton of the story just yet, but I am looking forward to seeing like where it goes. I'm really excited. Honestly, one of the things I'm most excited for is seeing all the companions that you can get, because you can get like 20 companions. You can build up your ship, you can bring different pilots, different people manning guns. Like, I want to recruit as many people as possible. Oh god, extreme heat, gas vent, protection region. I don't think this is gonna work on that. Your watch beeps faster as your suit runs out of protection. I haven't fully understood the survival aspects of this yet. That's silver there. I'm just grabbing this since we're on our way to the ship back here. I swear, if you're able to just fly over to this instead, then I'm gonna be a little upset. That's okay. I just really want to see, like, if we do this, will we unlock it as a new ship? Or... is that my... yeah, my suit is freaking out a bit. Can you play the character in first person? Well, there's your answer. Yeah, you can. And the giant, like, sphere I have out right now is just because I'm scanning the planet. Oh. What does this mean? Oh. What does that mean? Why is it beeping faster? Yeah, it's pretty good so far. I like it. Storm coming? Yeah, I see the storm. So I'm trying to get to this thing. There's a ship 200 meters out. I want to see what happens when you get to it. And then after that, we're going to go back to doing whatever else. Let me scan the water. Oh, thank you guys again for all the follows on TikTok. It looks like we hit the another goal, so I appreciate that. So your suit is running out of protection when you when it starts beeping fast. Yeah, I think we're kind of getting into a little bit of a dangerous area. You ran out of O2. Further exhaustion will cause CO2 buildup. Oh boy. Yeah, we need to get back to the ship. Oh, okay. So that's your stamina. The ship's right here. Crash site? Uh-oh, level 14. There's a Terramorph. Oh god. Wait, can I take this ship? Oh no, it's gotta be like crashed. Like there's no way we're getting this thing. Oh damn. All right, let's see. I'm gonna stay away from those guys. Let's try to just grab this. I'll grab what loot I can, and then we'll get out. Maybe ship parts? Yeah, that's why I kind of wanted to come over here. There's something right here. High-speed data cable? Oh my god, Vasco. You little rascal, man. Scared the hell out of me. Can I grab this? Vasco! Come on! I see it for like a split second and then it goes away. All right, whatever. It's just a little storage box. We scanned 7 out of 8 resources here though, so that's cool. Oh God. Vasco! Oh no! Stay alive, Vasco. I'm stuck in here. I'm not leveled for this. You have gained an affliction. Open the status menu. No, Vasco. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus Christ. What the hell? I shouldn't have come here. It's a level 10 enemy. Vasco's dead. Yeah, I wonder how the game works for companions. I'm level 2. I am level 2, dude. There's no way. Crit. Bring her down, lads. I need backup. Jesus. I swear, if I somehow defeat this thing, being a level 2, then I can take on anything. Oh God, my health. Crit? So happy that the gravity on this planet is very, very low. Oh God! No way, dude. No way a level 2 beats a level 10. Oh God, I'm out of ammo. Come on. Oh God, it needs to recharge. Oh. I'm swapping through every weapon I have. No way. Oh, we did it! Level 2! Oh wow. Yo, that was actually... Okay, Vasco. Oh, no. Is he still alive, though? He's alive! How do you feel right now? Hey, I'm feeling pretty good. I'm feeling... How did we just kill this thing? Being a level 2 and we just killed it. Yeah, that music kicked in there, and that felt pretty good too. Oh God. Whew. Yeah, we're gonna be playing a lot of Starfield over the next few days, so if you guys are looking forward to it, definitely make sure you hit that follow button. The game is only single player, but yes, it is literally Fallout in space. Looking better, feeling better, a lot more modern. So personally, I'm really excited. And this is only, what, I'm 2 hours into the game? I haven't even left this second planet that you get to. Do you need Xbox Live? I don't believe so. Not for this. Oh God. I need to let my CO2 get back. All right, we're gonna fast travel back to our ship here now too. I do love that feature. Anywhere you're on the planet, you can fast travel back to the ship. And you don't need you don't need Xbox Live in order to play it. Just straight up single player. So. Yeah, I'm playing it on PC. All right, let's fast travel over there. Let's see how this works. You're carrying too much and can't fast travel. I don't even know what I have equipped right now. My guy is one pound too heavy. Can I drop this? Helium? How do I know if something is, like, trash? Controls feel pretty good. Definitely compared, like, shooting feels a lot better compared to Fallout. The game's running decent for me so far.
To reach the launch, we must jump to the planet Jemison.
And now we fast travel back to our ship.
Land in the city of New Atlantis.
All right, so we're going to New Atlantis.
Second nature before too long.
Here, let's get up. Show you guys inside the there is no trash. Everything is treasure. True. Not wrong. What difficulty? I'm playing on just normal. I debated about bumping it. If it's a little bit too easy, then honestly, I'll bump it up to hard. But for right now, we're just going to try out on normal and see how it is. We're only 2 hours into the game, so the only crew member we have so far is Vasco. And before we go to the next mission, I just want to level up too. Where is... So it says select missions. Where is that? Missions in the bottom section. Oh, okay. It's in the bottom. Toggle which quest is tracked on your HUD. Only one quest can be tracked at a time. Select the name of the quest to expand the list of the open objectives. Select any objectives in the quest to track the whole quest. You can start set course button to automatically navigate to your active quest objective. So if we do this, grab jump to Jemison. Set course. Oh, okay, and then you can just straight up jump. Fuel consumption, 25 out of 50. Let's do it. Let's just jump straight to it. Starship entering front patrolling camp. Area.
This is United Colonies
wow.
Security.
That was like instant.
To be
scan in progress. Okay. Hey, we're good.
For landing at New Atlantis.
All right, moving engines down and putting it into shields. Where is New Atlantis? Ah, there it is. So, can I press R? Does it have survival? Yeah, there's still a good amount of survival. Go to the lodge. God. Whoops. Not bad. Go ahead and get up. So the nice thing is you can get up and get it, then get off your ship, or you can just straight up press the button and get off your ship. But we'll go ahead and do this. New Atlantis. Okay.
Hey, Bosco. What? No Barrett? Let me guess. Protocol Indigo again?
Yeah, sure.
And he's our new captain.
I'm using mouse and keyboard.
And you can stop by the Trade Authority kiosk if you need to offload some cargo.
1,000 credits, my ship need. I don't even know how much credits I have right now, sir. Like to modify, view and modify my ship. Let me see what ships you have for sale. Where'd you say I could sell things?
The Trade Authority runs a vending kiosk next to my booth. It's just off to the side, near the ramp. Besides that, Jemison Mercantile is your closest shop if you're looking for a bit of everything. That's further in, past the security checkpoint.
Okay.
Everything looks good here. I'll be at my booth if you need me.
Yeah, let's go ahead and take care of this one sec, chat. Alright, there we go. Imagine just going into a chat and just sitting there and wasting your life away saying just dumb stuff. I don't get it, man. If you don't want to play the game, don't play it. That's it. It's as simple as that. Go back to Madden, FIFA, No Man's Sky, whatever you want to play. Just every couple landings. And be happy with your life. It's not worth it. There's so many more important things, man. Whatever you want to play and makes you happy, follow that. But for I saw somebody ask for early access. It's officially out now for everyone. I've been on here for about 2 hours now since I was provided a key from Bethesda. So I've been checking out the game a little bit early, but it's officially out for everyone as long as you have the premium edition. Regular edition comes out on September 6th for everyone. And so far, I like it. I mean, we keep saying it, but it's literally Fallout in space. There's 20 companions that you can hire, manage your ship, change your ship, base building, survival stuff. There's a lot of things you can do. And then, plus being on PC, the modding capabilities that this game is going to have is going to be insane. So, what's the difference between premium and regular? Premium, you get the expansion. I think there's going to be an expansion at some point. And then you also get some extra, like, look to clothings and stuff. But, yeah, you can also, if you wait too, you can get it through Game Pass. So, if you're kind of on the edge and don't know, hey man, highly recommend. Just wait, like, a week or so, get it on Game Pass, and you'll be good. So, like to view and modify. Let's see what ships they have for sale.
I'm sure you can find something you like.
I have Game Pass. Yeah, so Game Pass with premium and it says I'm early. I heard that they're having some issues with it, so might have to keep checking it or so. They have 7 ships or 8 ships here? What the hell? You can fully customize a ship too, but honestly, I'm not very creative like that, so personally I would just buy a pre-built one. Damn, all these look pretty sick. It looks like you can add parts here. Starfreight's logistics. The Gladius one looks pretty cool. I like that. The Responder. Even this thing. This thing's like a freaking tank. Oh my god. What the hell? Shield Breaker is pretty sick too. It gives you some information. Where can I go if I need more crew for my ship?
I would try the viewport. It'll be on your left once you get into the plaza.
Okay, so we need to go to the viewport, and where do you say I can sell things?
Just check out the Trade Authority kiosk next to my booth. Otherwise, there's Jemison Mercantile further in.
Okay, cool. So he has like a trading port. Yeah, trade kiosk right here. So how do I know what is worth just selling? They all have different stats. So it looks like these are just worth selling like that. Weight, name, value. All right, let's sell this. I picked up some board games. Apparently board games sell for a pretty penny. Damage resistance. I wish there was a way to like sort by... The amps give you movement and jump speed. I wish you could sort by like treasure and other things. Shotgun shells. Deck of cards. Oh, the ships. They all have different stats. Oh, yeah. It looks like they all have different stats, too. Eon. I think I'm going to sell this pistol because now I have the other pistol. Wait, I have two of them? Oh, my God. I had three of them. Damn. I have two of these. 6-5. Some spiced worms, heal paste, helium. Common ingredient source. This item can be used in component and crafting. Okay. We'll hold on to that for now. Data cable. We don't need that. Iron. We'll hold on to. Beer in a juice box. Jacketed leatherware. Is that better than the one that I have right now? Looks like it might be. We have three maelstroms. We'll go ahead and sell those. Notepad, notebook, nutrients. Some of these are used for crafting, though. Molecule extractor. Use storage on your ship. Yeah, there's so much, like, we're already being given, so I need to figure out what to do with each thing. Charger helmet. Okay. So we could have put on that guy's clothing there. Rescue axe. I think we have three of these. Sedative, silver, smoked salmon. Syringe we can get rid of. I think we're wearing that mining pack. Battle meal. Utility headphones. Nice. Like you can actually put them on. Now if we go to Earth, there's a vault. Oh, really? That's pretty sick. There's an Easter egg there. Aw, oh, dude. That'd be cool. We'll have to check that out. What is going on? You have an affliction. Take the corresponding remedy to cure it. Go to your inventory and look for aid category with icons that can match your afflictions. Oh, just what if? Oh, you're saying what if there is one? Oh, that would be cool. I thought you were saying there is one. Go to the inventory and look for aid. So right now we have lung damage, acute lung damage. Oh God. Do we have an aid in our inventory? Use for treating afflictions. Okay, yeah, we can use this. Did that treat it? No. Sporadic 2 damage and detection event. Melee attacks use O2. Oh, treats can... Oh, wait, I'm stupid. It says contusions, lacerations, and puncture wounds. Bandages won't help there. What about others? Is there anything else that I have that can cure, like, lung damage? Med pack, maybe? Research projects require fewer resources for 10 minutes. Inhaler. Yo, what's up, Master? How's it? It's pretty good right now. The inhaler? Wait, where is that? Do you see it? Beef? I mean, unless if I don't have one. Med pack. Problem solving skills. Yeah, I don't think I have one then. The rest is all like food and items. So I'll have to... Maybe this guy sells some? Yellow ring above the med pack? Is that really? It's yellow? The lime? Is that the top? Oh, this? No, this is an enhancer. It's an amp enhancer. It's not a healer. It's a steroid-based enhancer designed to temporarily boost leg strength. Movement speed and jump speed. It doesn't say it cures lung damage, though. Yeah, we're gonna look for one. But so far, the game's pretty cool. Maybe we can buy stuff from this guy. So right now we have a good amount of cash. Genetic material amp. It says vendor buy, unless if this is saying vendor buy as in like he's gonna buy it. Don't tell me that I just bought stuff. Oh my god, did I just buy stuff? Oh no, I did sell. Okay. Whew. Oh god, it's hard to distinguish the two. Okay, I did sell. Oh my god, I thought I bought everything when we were in that first conversation with the guy. Oh no. I was gonna say, what the hell, man? I think this is the outfit that we got. The Argos Extractor jumpsuit. Ammo type, miscellaneous. Oh, miscellaneous is the stuff that we can sell. Going back and forth in this, I just don't know if my marriage can handle another 100-hour game. I totally get that. Drake. Oh, no, not again. The last time I heard that was when I played... when I played Saints Row. My character looked like Drake, too. Beware of Rocket Blast. Rocket blasts of departing and arriving spacecraft can cause physical harm, resulting in extreme bodily harm and or death. By order of the Civil Space Flight Authority. Okay. Let's see how many people we can talk to here. The lodge is up there, residential district's up there, commercial district. Dude, this kind of reminds me of the Citadel. Okay. RIP Saints Row. I know, Volition is shutting down, man. RIP. RIP, man. You receive one skill point to spend every time you level up. Each skill can also unlocks a challenge. Complete the challenge and then spend a skill point to rank up the skill. It's interesting. The top row represents basic skills. The row below are locked in until you spend a minimum number of skill points in that category. So physical, social, combat, science, and tech. So me being a diplomat, we started out with commerce, persuasion, succeed in 3 speech checks, and then you get a 10% increased chance for success when persuading somebody. Nice. Is early access today? Early access is officially right now. It officially started an hour and 15 minutes ago. So it's out for everybody that has early access. Increase the maximum health by 10%. It's actually pretty good. So what other social skills do we have here? Deception, this row is locked. Access to brand new worlds. So the one on the left is kind of like a breakdown of it, and then the one on the right is what you actually get. It's like a lore aspect, I guess, on the left. You can craft specific specialty food and drink and research additional recipes at the research lab. There's a chance you'll find extra credits when searching containers. Unlock the ability to pickpocket targets. Okay, I like that. I think I'm going to wait to use my point in persuasion. But let's check the rest of these. Is there anything that gives you more XP, maybe? Combat. Ballistic weapons do more damage. Melee weapons do more. Laser do more. Pistols, shotguns, and that's it. Science, increased grab jump range. It looks like this is going to be mainly for flying around. Get common and uncommon inorganic resources from surface objects. Med packs restore you more. Resources required to craft items and complete research projects is reduced by 10%. Pretty good. Add an optional zoom to the hand scanner, and scan distance is increased to 20 meters. That would be pretty useful. Tech, looks like that's for your ship. You can attempt to hack to advanced locks, and 2 auto attempts can be banked. Unlock ship target functionality. Damn, there's actually there's a good amount of stuff in here. I'm going to go for the surveying. Adds an optional zoom to the hand scanner. I feel like that's going to be worth having for resources. And I'd either go security or I'm going to go medicine. Early on, I feel like that's going to be worth having. And right now, I'm on PC myself. Let's quick save. All right, let's see who we can talk to.
Do this. What? No, just no.
Okay.
I've never been in a battle. Everyone kept telling me to keep my eyes closed, but it's kind of hard to do that when you're running. At first, I thought it was a cryptic mercenary shooting at us, but it wasn't. It was these other people yelling about serpents and stuff.
Is there a level cap? That is a good question. Galaxy is a tough place, kid.
Is that really an appropriate thing to say to a child?
Okay.
Anyway, I'm fine now. I hope my parents don't take too long getting here.
Yeah, I'm not sure about that. Scientist Ricardo?
Guess you caught some of that, huh? The galaxy is at peace and somehow seems more dangerous than ever. Spacers, House Varun,
talk to the scientist by the tree.
Everyone trying to grab their piece. What happened to the early days, huh? When we just float through the stars and dream.
I hear that.
But hey, just stepping out your door is dangerous. What happened was a tragedy, of course, but I've had way more good happen in my life than bad. The galaxy's still pretty wonderful. It'll take more than this to make me think otherwise.
Who are you?
Ricardo Bosch. I was the lead researcher on the station that got attacked. It was business as usual until those
just created my character for an hour. In,
spouting
it
their
took me a while
was.
To.
Even the Marines were overwhelmed. Honestly, I'm just lucky to have made it out of there in one piece. We all are. Now, I just want to get back to work. Where is that woman?
House Varun, what is that?
Not what, who?
Yeah, I get a mix between, like, Cyberpunk, Fallout, and even a little bit of Mass Effect vibes
for the game. Imagine a bunch of colonists who set off into the stars ages ago, disappeared, and then re-emerged as a sort of religious society. Faction, or cult, whatever you want to call them. They believe in some sort of celestial deity called the Great Serpent. Real nightmare fuel kind of stuff. About 100 years back, they picked a fight with pretty much everyone in the settled systems. I guess your school never... We eventually made peace.
Didn't mean to do that.
Sort of. Then they just disappeared. They're out there somewhere. Or so folks assume. The ones that attacked us, they were the hardliners for sure. You meet those guys, you run.
Yo, Dread Fulu, thank you for the follow there on Twitch. So you've run into the Crimson Fleet too? I'll check my here. Let's see what our frames at right now.
That I have had to dump a load of cargo.
So we
just
got to
year.
The city.
Microscopes.
About 60, 65.
Yes, you can sell anything.
63, 64.
Pirates are a tricky lot.
On high ultra-ish.
They jump in, steal your stuff, and get out of there fast. Keep your cool, and you can generally talk your way out of it, so long as you're not too attached to your valuables. Stumble upon them planet side, though.
Dumb nuke. Thank you for the follow there, too.
Get much itchier.
All right, let's
not
see.
What?
Whoops, I didn't mean
faction.
To do that.
About 100 years.
I clicked the same one again.
You meet those guys? Another time, then.
Okay. Nice.
Private sector.
Hello.
Now that's where the real money's at.
Okay.
Cool
spacesuit. Hey, thanks. Citizen, all right. I'm guessing people would just name Citizen. We don't really need to talk to. Authorized personnel only. Yeah, there is a VATS-like system in the game. Haven't used it yet or found it, but it's supposedly it is in there somewhere. They showed it in the trailers before. Space travel seems fine for me so far. I mean, you can fast travel to planets just through menus, or you can fly there yourself and then toggle it, depending on how you want to go about it. The people slamming this game probably grew up on iPads, Fortnite, and never played older RPGs. Completely agree, man. Completely agree. Hey, man. All they play nowadays is battle royales.
This is New Atlantis Transit.
So I get it.
Or...
which is fine. Like, if that's what you're into, like, it's all about what you're into. But any day, I'd rather play a story game, RPG, or something new. Than, you know, than that. And that's just my style. Like, whatever. The thing that crosses the line is when you go out trashing other people's experience, trying to make their experience lesser because you're not interested in it. That's when it's like, okay, bro, like, you go play whatever you want to play and don't spend the time of day doing that. Like, it just doesn't make sense.
One day.
Yeah, people like army guy here, like that, saying that single player games are not worth it. Like, I don't know, man. That's some yeah. Exactly. Where are we headed here?
Not fractured.
Yeah, I mean, right now for single player games, you've got Baldur's Gate, you've got this game, I mean, Spider-Man in like a month. What else? I don't know. But right now, I think now's a better time than ever.
City, but Constellation is an entirely neutral entity and always has been.
People are complaining when it's not working, when it's Bethesda, what they expect. I feel that.
Here we
no,
are.
It's definitely,
launch,
you definitely had to have, you know, some expectations
that
on that.
You.
Like, I knew
I
there was going to be some bugs.
The other members
but...
of Constellation. They will be waiting for us inside.
Is this game live on Game Pass now? Not yet. Fortunately, only if you buy the, like, upgrade on Game Pass. It's out.
Just inside. If Barrett were
yeah,
here,
Fallout 76 launch was had plenty of issues too. Now,
and he hopes you'll make this place your home.
All right, let's get in here. Let's meet the constellation, and then we'll start exploring the planet a little bit more.
Welcome to Constellation. We have a lot to talk about. Would you care to tell us what happened to our friend? Why you're here and he isn't?
Well, you see, pirates attacked. Barrett asked me to deliver the artifact.
I see. Vasco, verify.
All statements made have been factual.
He's gonna fact check me?
It's just typical. Barrett hands over our ship and our robot to some random employee of that discount mining outfit he uses.
Walter.
And if we hadn't insisted on installing those emergency protocols, I guarantee you this rock breaker here would be halfway to Neon.
But that didn't happen. He's here with the artifact.
Thank you, Mateo. Now, let's focus on what's in front of us, shall we? What happened when it was extracted? Did anyone see anything? Hear anything?
It was bright lights and music.
Interesting.
Kind of was.
Similar to Barrett's description of the experience, with less embellishment.
Are you hearing this?
Smash.
You all believe me now?
Permanently reduce. Oh, wait, there's guides out there? Permanently reduces fall damage by 5%. Oh, I didn't know that. It's like bobbleheads, but they're called guides.
Gentlemen,
that's awesome.
Please focus. Noelle, I think it's time we tested your theory.
Right. Let's see.
All right, what's our theory?
We know the artifacts react to each other. The pieces we already have.
This guy is smiling at me a little bit too much.
Now,
there.
If we add this new Sir. One to the two we already have.
The artifact. If you could place it on the table here.
Alright, let me just go ahead and put this right
That's
there.
It. Just like the others. And to imagine, we thought there were only two of them at first.
How's combat? It's starting to feel a little bit better.
Oh my god, that's it. They're reacting. Look at how it's coming together. That energy that's arcing between them, no manufactured material in the settled systems can do that. None of them. This proves that.
Easy, girl. Breathe. You'll have a heart attack.
She's not the only one. If they're coming together, that means there's a set.
Built by an intelligence.
Artifacts is just. Yeah, these are the pieces of Eden, actually.
For our little wager, Godfrey?
You're on, Walter.
Well. If we had all the answers,
we're searching for the apple.
Exciting. Now, would it?
Not to take away from the moment, but what are we going to do about our new friend?
What are you going to do with me?
So, are you ready to get to work? See if exploration is the life you want to lead in this little universe of ours?
How much do you know about the artifacts? What are they?
Individually, they're just odd hunks of metal. Another oddity from the uncharted reaches of space. As to what they are, what they're building. Well, you'll be part of solving that puzzle now.
Alright, well, you want me in the Constellation? What does that mean? What's expected?
We're all here because we're committed to exploring space. Humanity may have settled the stars, but that doesn't mean we should stop diving into the unknown. Beyond that, you'll be expected to use your own judgment, just like the rest of us.
All right, I'm in. Tell me what's next.
You should take some time to get settled in. Introduce yourself to everyone. Some of our members aren't here, but you'll meet them soon. Come find me when you're ready. You and I are going to be doing some traveling together. Get your feet wet. And here, I think you've earned something for bringing the artifact to us. In addition to credits.
Wait, is that an actual thing, Eddie?
Why don't we set you up with a backpack with some boost?
People are playing No Man's Sky, saying it's Starfield.
Just mind your head.
That's funny, actually. Nice, we leveled up again. Hey, I'll take it. Yes. That's actually great. That is funny. I thought you were like doing the opposite, honestly. I thought you were saying that I'm playing No Man's Sky. I don't know. I thought you were basically saying the opposite, but that's funny. That's actually good. I'm gonna unlock the security system here. Because then we can start hacking advanced locks, and I feel like that down the line that'll be worth having. Like, three streams are doing it on TikTok right now. That is... oh my god. My face is tired.
I've occasionally had my doubts about Constellation as an investment. But now...
this is cozy.
Well...
Lilith?
It's clearly money well spent.
Wonder if there will be legendary perks?
This is all exciting, but... there's really a lot of pressure on us, isn't there? We have to get this right.
Oh god, my guy's coughing still. We have the affliction. Yeah, I still can't believe... well, so earlier today, we defeated a level 10 enemy as level 2. Oh, I'm allowed to go up here. Because I have the lodge key. So every planet you can you go to, you can nice, a bunch of free credits here. Report on Constellation. Thanks speech. Oh, this is my room. Oh, okay. Wait, what is that? Funky sphere sculpture. Nice. Uh-oh. Wait, did my damage... oh, no. My lung damage is getting worse. Or did it just damage me a little bit right now? Okay. The heck is that? Yo, this place is cozy. Report... okay. Is there a you know what I need to figure out? Is there a button pick up everything and sell it? I do need to sell some stuff. You're a fast reader. Yeah, I already scanned it with my mind. I use the you know, those tadpoles, man, come in handy, man. Buy some ammo, true. It would be a good idea. Is there a toggle HUD button in here? I see auto move. I would love a toggle HUD button so that way I could just like turn it off for a second, take screenshots and stuff. It was super easy making thumbnails for fast travel to ship R. Oh, okay, when you're looking at the surface map. What else? Looking for... is there like... you know what's nice? When games have like a search button for a setting. There might not be a UI like toggle. But taking screenshots in Baldur's Gate is like super easy because you can just press a button, turn off the HUD, take a picture of a character, boom, set it as a thumbnail. This game's going to be a little bit harder, but that's okay. There is a photo mode though, so like pressing that is a little bit easier. Like this. How do I hide it? What was that? Power? Toggle menu. There you go. What other... wait, okay, what else do we got here? What's up? Wave, sneak, sit on ground, jump, cower, boxer, none. What else? There's not like a change clothing option. Okay. Well, good to know. Oh, there's a toggle helmet. I see. Honestly, the scan option is really nice because you can actually, it highlights stuff. I wish there was a way you could highlight items without being in that though. Genetic sample bottle, value. Oh, you can actually see the value of stuff too. Like vials. Some tissues. Cosmetic supply box apparently is worth a lot. Is this a pharmaceutical lab? Treat infections. Yeah, here we go. So this is what we need to find one that treats lung damage. The injector. Oh, here it is. Used to administer medication that treats afflictions. Brain injury, concussion, heat stroke, hernia, hypothermia, lung damage. Oh, God. It's too real. We need to find one of those. Lotion and tissues. Whoa there. Hey, whoa. Hey, they got tissues in the hallway too. Nice. A deck of cards. Dude, deck of cards sell for good value. And board games. Chat, keep that in mind. Board games and deck of cards actually sell for like over 100 credits each time. So, personal digi frame, a drink pack, bottle opener. Can I use this? Like it's shut off. Even weights sell for pretty good too. Do I have my flashlight on? Do now. Whoa. Even these fans sell for a lot. What's inventory space like? Inventory space is like okay, to be honest. It's is it the Apollo landmark on Luna? Whoa. Wait, we just found a book that says visit the Apollo landmark on Luna. That's sick. Oh my god, that thing's worth 655? We're gonna have to find a lot of this stuff to sell. So inventory is like okay. You can see all the new items you got here. It's kind of hard to see on TikTok, which by the way, we're also on Twitch, YouTube, and Kick, which is Casas Plays TV on Twitch and then Casas Plays on YouTube and Kick. But once you pick up items, then you kind of just see them right here and you can see their weight, value. I kind of wish there was another like inventory where you could see it in boxes instead. Like this, you have to scroll through it, which is a little bit... okay. The potato phone freak leaks made the graphics look so much worse. This actually looks great. Yeah, I think it's actually, like, pretty good. Oh, is this my... This looks like my ship. Or, like, a model like it. I mean, yeah, there's some areas where the lighting isn't great and other stuff, but honestly, I think generally like it's fine. There's been worse games out there that I've played. Binoculars, pick up these. I'm picking up everything that is worth a lot. It's a weapons case. What the heck is this room? Grab the digipick. Did you see it? I didn't see one. Yeah, digipicks are lockpicks too. So keep an eye out for those. Storage room. Ah, yes. This is my room. Tissues. Okay, here's a conference room where we're gonna have all of our important meetings and stuff. Picking up everything that is worth money. Estra, thank you for the follow there on Twitch. Appreciate that. Burwood Bandit. Thank you for the follow there too. Oh, whoops, this takes me back outside. Coming from TikTok? Welcome, welcome. Yeah, whatever platform you guys prefer the most. Is the game trash? I would say no. Personally, I don't really call games trash, number one. But personally, I think there's a lot more trash games out there that you could potentially call trash, and this will not really be one of them. My opinion of a trash game is a game that gets re-released every year with little to no changes. Madden, FIFA,
something
NBA, etc.
Sarah's the best possible person to running Constellation.
And even then, they still have... I mean, I've been playing Madden off stream. You guys would never expect it, but I've been playing Madden almost like every day to wake me up a little bit, which is funny enough. But I would never stream it or play it, but it's kind of funny. Enjoying it? Yeah, I'm enjoying it so far. There's a lot to see. Like, it makes me want to explore the world and see what's out there.
Are you ready to get to work? Or was there something else?
Okay, let's come back to her. Let's go explore first.
I hope you are satisfied with the quarters.
Got a favorite NFL team? I don't follow sports in any way, shape, or form. So the only thing I can say is the Eagles, because I'm from right outside of Philadelphia. So is Shattered Space Story a DLC? I think so. If that's the thing that is mentioned, I'm pretty sure it is. Let me check my settings again. Yeah, we're gonna head to the commercial district, because number one, we need to sell some stuff, and number two, I want to try to get that inhaler too. So I'm gonna turn effects down a little bit. Music is fine. Ammo too. Yeah, we'll probably need to get some ammo. Let's edit the settings again. Crowd density, rendered scale resolution. Reduce to increase performance. Shadow quality, we'll bump that down. I've heard that having that high is making it a little bit tough. Indirect lighting. Contact shadows, we'll bump down a little bit. FSR2 actually, I feel like is doing like okay. Enable VRS, variable rate shading during rendering. We'll turn that off. See if this is any better. It's a lot of the changes I make, it doesn't really change much. Like, I'm still getting like 65 frames, which is fine. I mean, as long as it's over 60 consistently, I mean, that's okay with me. Oh god, I forgot we have stamina. Wait, can we fast travel to places like that? Like, say if I want to travel to the commercial district. Fast travel to ship? I don't think so. We're on our way to the residential district. Can I set an icon to like go there? I'm gonna have to unsubscribe since you said Eagles, my Cowboys fan. Hey man, I don't even care at all about that. I mean, I watch S-Fan all the time, and he's like a
you gotta let her go.
Cowboys fan.
We got the other truth.
Dude, if anything, I feel embarrassed to say Eagles. Because of the way some people act. So yeah. Welcome to New Atlantis. Let's see. Alright, let's go through all the lore. Alright, that's good. That's good. That's good. Mast. I'm just opening these to see if they open or give me any information on like quest lines. Oh, nice. Residential district. Chunks. What is that? Mercury Tower? So you can buy apartments and stuff. Pioneer Tower. There's a clothing store right here. Wait, I should turn off my light. Probably blinding this guy. Gotta watch
Welcome
the stream.
Thanks for choosing Chunks. Which Chunks would you like today?
Like to buy some Chunks.
I'm happy to serve you.
This guy an android? Wait, he's got AIDS. Or not that kind of AIDS. He's got cheesesteak package? No way, dude. Wait, these are literally just MREs. He's got what? He's got beneficial items that can aid you in upping your performance. Oh wait, you can also use the kiosk. Oh boy. Yeah, let me just buy it from here instead of off him. Alright, no, we don't need to buy any aids right, I mean drinks right now. How do I get inside this shop, man? This looks cool. You don't gotta call out my dude like that. Citizen. Oh, I can just go up to the tower? What we got here?
I do hope you are enjoying your time.
There
is
simply
no parallel to the food you will find here. One taste, and I'm sure you'll agree.
This place looks expensive.
The Dawn's Roost represents the highest quality, from the ingredients to the decor. No expense is spared. Anyone who has sampled our offerings will assure you it is all worth it.
Okay.
Enjoy the rest of your day.
If the bartender has a mystery drink for you to
patron,
try...
Patron? What if I just, like, took this? You can actually... just walk over. Nice. Family apartments. Oh. Oh man, I don't have the
Sergeant Yumi's looking for reliable people to help the guard. Contact him if you're interested. We'd all appreciate it.
Where is he?
Hi. How you doing?
Oh nice. We got a quest. Apollo Burger. Oh god. I'm running too much.
That movie was epic. Definitely better than the last interceptor.
Interceptor. Okay, there's nobody. Hello? Can I go up here? Floor access restricted. How's the game so far? It's pretty cool. We're at New Atlantis right now. Centurion Arsenal. Oh, they got weapons here. Hell yeah, brother. A mini bot? Activate.
There's something to be said for brand loyalty. I'd much rather have someone comfortable with their purchase than some mythical best possible buy.
There, I'm telling you, if this game does not have a I'm insert similar name to Commander Shepard and this is my favorite store, I'm gonna be so upset. This game has to have an Easter egg that mentions that.
You're here because you can go in third person too. Something you can count on. Am I right? Welcome to Centurion Arsenal. It is my absolute pleasure to assist you with any purchases or questions you may have. Okay. All sales are final, but that won't matter because you will undoubtedly be pleased with your purchase. You have my word.
You take this all pretty seriously.
Is that a surprise? These are potentially matters of life and death we're talking about here.
Well, you're not wrong there. What would you recommend?
Well, that's not a simple question, is it? It all depends on who's asking. I have my own personal favorites, but I wouldn't presume to know yours. Tell me, were you to find yourself in the unfortunate position of needing to use a weapon, what suits you best? Something up close and personal?
Oh, I thought I was actually going to answer
Rapid
that.
Rapid fire? Is precision a consideration?
Oh, here we go. It's just easier if everything explodes. I like to keep my distance while I can.
Ah, yes. Well, then personally, I would point you towards Combatech.
Okay, let's see what you have for sale.
Only the finest collection of armaments in the settled systems.
Okay. Can you sell stuff at any time? Damn, we have 14,000 credits now? Sheesh. So these are all the... Oh, Coachman. Combat knife. That's pretty sick. Coachman's a shotgun. Yo, that looks sick. I thought it was an LMG. All right, it's not as sick as I thought. Still looks cool. But it also costs 13,000. Wait, how much credits does this cost? Oh, 26,000. Damn. Modifier arc welder, modified Eon. Oh, that's cool. Wait, you know what I never thought? Wait, can you modify weapons too? Suppress? The game does not have good reviews. Have you seen Open Critic? Wait, did I just buy that? Open Critic has it as like a 87 or something, which is mighty. Or something like that. Your ship will eventually have a weapon table to mod. Got it. Yeah, I completely forgot about being able to do that. Okay, I don't think we can go into the residential shops yet. CJ's open 49 hours. What is?
CJ's is always open. Matter what you need.
Plastic
you need
pack.
It. I'm here.
Hey, what up, CJ? I can't talk to you from across the table, so I'm gonna have to jump on the table. I hope you don't mind. Here we go.
Thanks for stopping by. What brings you in?
How's business?
Nice and steady. Just the way I like it.
I've 88 got a good location, on Metacritic. Oh,
plenty
nice.
Of foot traffic,
oh, Metacritic.
And a ton of people who are in a hurry and need to make a quick stop for the essentials. Things keep going this way. I'm going to start opening franchises all over the settled systems.
I don't know what the who to trade stuff to. Like, I don't know if it counts more somewhere else than other places, but you like it here in New Atlantis?
You kidding me? Nowhere else like it in the settled systems. First time I came here as a kid, I knew I was going to come back and make my mark on this city. Nowhere I'd rather be. And now that I've got this place up and running, it's all coming together.
Hey, let's see what you got for sale.
I've got all your basics right here.
What do you got? All right, this guy's got AIDS too. He's got cheese. A lot of cheese. Heal pay. Oh, wait. Okay. We're getting somewhere. He's got med packs. Please stop. wait, he might have, does he have, ooh, he's got udon? Nice. Udon mini bite, multi-pack udon? No way, bro. Wait, easy sleep. Oh, that's cool. These give you XP bonuses. Plus 2% XP gain for 15 minutes. The Triforce. Tomato. Buy the coffee cup and see if he mispronounces your name. That's actually good. Wait, yeah, so I did accidentally buy the weapon over there. Soba? What is soba? Dinner with sesame oil? Ramen? He's got some ramen too? Damn, okay. Oh man, they always have heel paste. Medicated cream. Nice. You know what? I might actually buy that though. That peach kiats. Damn, look at that thing. Woo! Oh my god. Damn. Okay, I'm done. Anyways, more cheese, bandages, a baguette. Would you like to buy this? Let's see, what else we got? I need that peach ASAP. I'm dying out here. First impressions? It's pretty much what I expected, and I'm down with it. Oh, so you can only sell things that are related to the store that you're in. So we do need to go to like a trader's kiosk.
Have a good one.
But yeah, first impressions, I mean, the game runs decent. For me, it's been loading pretty fast. Traveling feels like all right. You can fast travel everywhere, or you can fly there, walk there yourself. Let's see what this guy's saying. The story is interesting so far. I mean, we're still like really early on.
Is it real? Hell if I know, but they think it is, and that makes them dangerous.
Okay. Thought that guy was going to give me a quest or something. There's another kiosk here. There's definitely a lot to see. It's kind of crazy. And even a little bit intimidating, too. Like, I'm over here in who knows where. Let's go inside this clothing shop. What kind of specs is your PC? Wondering how my 3060... So I have a 3080 Ti, an i7 12th gen, and 32 gigabytes of DDR5. I have the game mostly on high settings. Inside here, right now, we're getting 90 frames. Outside, I get about 65. It's actually probably the highest frames I've gotten so far. I just got 26 for a second there. 100... Yeah, right now we're at like 102.
Please let me know if I may assist you. You won't find a larger array of options in all the settled systems, I guarantee you.
I guarantee you. Nice. What a beautiful... You know what's crazy? We're in the residential area. We're not even in the commercial area. Actually, let's just see what he's got. So, can you... I'm curious. Nice. Corpo power suit. Nice. Salary suit. Fashionable suit. Is there transmog in this game? Formal suit. He's definitely got some fashionable stuff. Oh, there's persuasion chance with these too. All right. Compared to equipped. Yes. Oh, absolutely. Yes, we are getting this. Oh my god. Yes, slay. Oh my god. Okay, I'm done. Urban. Persuasion chance. White. Neo City poncho. Some of these actually give you some good stat bonuses. The persuasion chance, though, is pretty good. Were you able to create your character? Yeah, I was able to. There's a good amount of customization too. So I took my time getting through there. Yo, I'm getting the Neo City Corp wear. That looks pretty sick. Yep, we got it. It gives us a persuasion chance,
too. I'll
see
you again, I'm sure.
Go ahead and throw that on. Persuasion chance. The only thing is, I wish you could, like, do you have to wear this? Hide. Oh, here you go. Hide spacesuit in settlements. So is it hiding now? I think it is. There's a T to hide spacesuits and settlements. Let's try the helmet too. Hide helmets in breathable areas. All right, so if I go like this now. Hey. Nice. Oh my God, dude, my guy. I actually feel like my guy's a linebacker or something. Not bad. Go for the tackle. Go for the tackle.
Ever run into spacers? Scumbags and scavengers. They're like vultures, picking away at the leftovers of the colony war.
Oh, medical. Okay, here we go.
Scouring through old labs and facilities.
I do think that the first person feels pretty good too, though.
I'm not feeling that bad.
Husband, patient, citizen.
We have an appointment. You're seeing the doctor. That's it.
Wait, can I talk to them?
Maybe some
it's taken
time.
Weeks of talking.
I have
to
that
get
report
it.
That's
okay, never mind. Hello? I need to get some items. Can I talk
Should
to the doctor?
Should you find yourself in need, medical supplies are available for purchase at, if I may say, very competitive prices. Welcome to our line.
Yes.
If you're in need of medical
Not much
assistance
has changed.
Or require supplies, I am sure we can accommodate you.
I need help, Doc.
All right. What can I do for you? All right. Little patching up, and you'll be all set.
How much are you going to charge? 400 credits? How much does it cost
Reliant
for a thing?
Medical is always...
I could use some medical supplies.
You certainly come to the...
Do you have any of these... Treats infections, lacerations, heal pace. Ah, yes. Oh my God, it's so much easier to do it myself. This stream's helping me stay calm while playing Darker and Darker. Hey, keep it safe out there. You know, Withers was only 200 for a revive. Oh man. Where's Withers when you need him? Yeah, we're gonna buy these injectors. Honestly, I'll buy all three. Junk flush, I'll buy. Oh my God, that costs so much. Health for 2 minutes. I wish it would tell you how many you already had. But some of these I'd rather like be stocked up on than not have enough. All right, cool.
You remain in good health.
Yeah, it was cheaper for me to buy it from him like that rather than have him do it for me. Is it worth the 100? Well, for full transparency, I was provided a key for the game from Bethesda, but I was going to pick up the game regardless. And for myself, this game would have been worth it, yes, picking up, because I know I'm going to get the time and the, I know I'm going to get pretty much the time out of it. For you, I mean, that'll be your personal call, but for me, if I was to buy this right now, I would have been satisfied with buying it in itself. So, wait, my health thing is gone. Oh, I'm healed up. Why do you run out of... Oh, it's because we're using too much energy, I think. All right, let's get to the... Can you fast travel to the lodge? Yes, you can. You can also fast travel to the district there. Dude, why is my CO2 like still dropping? All I'm doing, is my guy encumbered? He might be encumbered right now. Yep, he is. Ah, shoot. I gotta drop something. Let's sort by weight. Constellation pack, basic. Oh, nice. Wait, that's way better than my current thing. We accidentally bought the suppressed maelstrom, but honestly, I'll take it. Yeah, I would gladly take that. What game would you compare this to? The closest game I would compare this to, in all honesty, would be, I'd say Fallout 4 in space. With a little bit of Cyberpunk and a little bit of Mass Effect. Add those all together and you get Starfield. Inventory management seems rough as per usual. Yeah, inventory management's a little bit tough. Right now, at least.
I have a feeling today's going to be a great day.
Donna.
Don't you agree?
Sure. Yeah, every day is a great day.
I'm so excited to see Tony after work.
How's it going? We begin
to live. Oh, hi there. I'm doing great. How about you?
Hey, I'm doing terribly. Huh. I've been struggling to find the meaning in my life. Yes. That seems like a great intro.
Don't be a stranger.
Oh, no.
Another day, another credit.
Wait, say, how's it going there again? Same here.
Glad to hear it.
Hey.
Yeah. Life is good, isn't it? I've been trying to save up enough money so that I can go explore the settled systems with my boyfriend, Tony. I think we're finally getting close.
Oh, yeah.
What's the word for
no
that
offense
again?
You look at, how's it? Well,
oh, it's on the tip of my tongue.
You want to leave New Atlantis?
I've got no idea.
Why?
Tony and I want to see what else is out there. I love my job, but there has to be more to life than just being a janitor in New Atlantis. What about you? Have you gone on any adventures?
Oh, you have no idea. I'm working for I don't know if we should just tell anybody this, but sure. I'm working with Constellation to hunt down artifacts.
Whoa. I have no idea what that means, but that sounds really important.
Maybe we could recruit her and Tony?
I'll keep my eyes peeled for any artifacts, okay?
Okay. Anything you recommend doing in New Atlantis?
Well, that depends. Are you a foodie or a shopper?
I do enjoy spending a few credits from time to time.
You should check out the commercial district. There's some cool shops there. And if you want a whole new look, there's even an enhance.
Okay.
Take care.
All right, let's get on here. Transit car. Let's go over to the commercial district. All this tech and robots, yet she still has a damn broom. I know, right? Crazy. Not wrong.
Look at it.
Oh, nice.
It took years to get it looking just like this.
Wait, I've seen this guy before. He was at the hospital too.
A joke of a job.
All right, so what is over here?
Already stowed.
Colonist.
Both.
The well's been having brownouts all the time. Waiting in the Mast corridor. Finally sent someone down there. All right. But nothing's then changed.
Investigate the brownouts in the well. Interesting. Let's go into UC distribution. What is this? United Colonies. Yet instantly, the second you get indoors, the frame rate, like, increases.
Please, if you experience any issues in your dealings with the distribution center, let us know. We're always striving to improve.
Okay.
Welcome to UC Distribution. Now, before you say a word, I am required to inform you that formal complaints cannot be filed until the customer feedback system is back online.
Oh,
yeah?
I have
been told
how
it will be up and running in 2 weeks, but you know how these things are. I am sorry for any potential inconvenience.
Uh-huh.
Also, if you're here about a corporate account, I've been assured that deliveries will be back on schedule soon.
I'd like to see what you have for sale.
Oh, well, certainly.
Well, yeah, I don't even know what they do here. What do they do? Oh, they sell ammo? Whoa. I don't know what that is, but okay. Copper. What the hell? They sell a very wide variety of stuff. Fragments. Gold? Hey. Do they just like buy anything that... What the hell? they have so much. Polymer. Oh, they have armor too. You see Marine space helmet? That's pretty sick. Yeah, can I tell like how much I have right now? Ammo wise? Like, I don't even know. It'd be nice if I could see like, oh, you have like 200 and... Yeah, I don't even know what kind of ammo I need though. I know I have some of these. I'll buy some of this. Not all of it, but we'll buy like, I don't know, 100 rounds. I'll buy some of this too. 100. All right.
You're always welcome back, if you don't mind a bit of a wait.
I'm on tax duty tomorrow. Can't wait! Working at the distribution center can be tiring, but it sure is rewarding.
Sounds like you really love your job.
Of course, who wouldn't? It's such a privilege to be able to work for the UC government, a true force of good. Every day is so exciting. I get to meet so many new people, solve interesting problems, and learn about developing situations throughout the settled systems. Yep, there's never a boring day at the distribution center.
Hey, as long as he's happy.
Take care of yourself.
Yeah, you too. Security monitoring on this premises? Okay, let's get out of here. Thank you again for all the follows on TikTok, by the way, guys.
You're out there a lot,
right? We destroyed the first two goals tonight, and we're 8 followers away from the next goal.
In space, just do us all a favor and never turn into one of those.
Outlands. Okay. Is it only first person? No, you can go in the third person also. And you can do like
I feel.
Combat in third person. You can really play the entire game in third person.
Well, you're only as safe as your equipment out there.
But yeah. There's so many places that like you walk in and you're like unsure what it is. I don't even know what I'm looking at right now, sir.
Welcome to Outland. We deal in only the finest, most reliable gear for whatever adventures may await you. All of our products come highly recommended by individuals who have devoted their lives to distant travel. And while I've never needed them myself, I stand by everything we offer.
I'm surprised you don't use any of the things you sell.
I've never left the planet, so no, I do not.
What do you think of the shipbuilding? I haven't done anything yet so far with shipbuilding. I'm probably going to buy just like regular...
Yes, by all means, have a look.
Builds. Or like templates. I probably won't go out of my way and buy like or build one myself. I'm not that creative. Mobile game vibes? Hey man, you're playing some wild mobile games. Hey, I need to know what kind of phone you're using these days. Navigator. Helmets. Ground crew. It's actually kind of cool. Yeah, I really like that you can hide your clothing, though, or your spacesuit when you're in an area that you don't need to.
Good luck on all your adventures.
Let's go out here. It's a game so far. I've been having a good time with it. I'm doing a lot of exploration right now. I need to find a trading vendor because there's a lot of items I need to sell, but I can't find any. Oh, here's the bank. Oh God. What can we do in the bank? Peace in mind comes without special interest. 2.9% now. Don't tell me we can actually invest. No way.
As always, all Galbank trend. With Galbank, your money is always safe.
Now listen, I have a lot on my plate right now, and you don't look like a new hire stumbling through their first day. Now, who exactly are you?
Who are you? Just the starship captain seeing what New Atlantis has to offer.
Really? Huh. You have your own ship? Oh, this is perfect. Kismet, really. I have a business.
Spent like over an hour in the city. Yeah, we've been walking around from building to building here.
Very lucrative.
Yeah? You're buttering me up pretty thick. I'm not saying that. I'm interested.
Good. Great. Well, confession time. I might just be a little desperate.
Okay.
See, the world credit analysis, you know, dealing with deadbeats and reprobates is, it's a tough field. What I need is a ringer, someone that can collect some of our top delinquent offenders. What I need is...
Bill Clinton.
You work with me, and the fee you get will be huge.
All right. Tell me about the mark, then. Wait, how many credits are we talking about? Let's hear.
Oh, I can tell you're eager. That's good. But we'll start small and work our way up to the worst offenders.
All right, well, tell me about the mark, then.
Yes. So, we got a Galaxy-class con man took out a loan to franchise a restaurant. Turns out, surprise, it was a scam. And Dieter Maliki jumps system. Now, he's holed up in a literal shack in the middle of nowhere. Can you believe it? The job is simple. Get Dieter to pay. And we don't want him dead.
Oh, so
we
now...
don't want him hurt. Just close his account like an honest citizen.
Okay. Is he dangerous?
Well, I mean, yes. We're not the only ones looking for him. And you don't dome up on a dust bowl unless you're serious about dodging your civic responsibilities.
Well, he said they don't want him dead, so what happens if he dies?
If he dies, then his assets go to probate, and we can get paid. So if he forces you into an it's you or him situation, it's A-okay for Galbank's bottom line if
of course
him.
It is.
But I cannot stress this enough. This is not the ideal outcome. We wanted him liquidated, and we'd have put a tracker on him.
All right. Well, let's collect some debt.
I'll send over all the details. You find Dieter and bring his account current. I hate to end on this note, but, you know, not everyone's a straight arrow. If you cut a deal with Dieter, honestly, I have no way of knowing. But don't expect any more jobs from me. Best of luck. I believe in you.
Okay. That's actually pretty cool. Can we just, like, see that, too? So if I go to, like, this... activity, so we have due in full, so that's an actual mission, and then these are all, oh damn, these are like investigation stuff, and this is an actual mission. Can we show on map? Is he on this planet here? Or, oh my god, oh, he's on a level 20 planet. Well, we ain't getting there, and not anytime soon. In order to get there, we'd have to jump here, and then from there we'd jump to there. And it looks like you have to fill up your thing with more fuel, too. Yeah, we'll definitely have to do that. I mean, I'm not really the level for it yet, but it's on my to-do list. Kind of just exploring here to see what missions we can get. But I think we're almost ready. Apply for a job at the... Industries kiosk. What is that? Are you working for them? It's over there. There's a structure all over there. Oh god. What's going on right here?
Yes, exactly. It's like
when someone insults you.
Apply for a job? What is that? Oh, these are. Oh god, this is one of the religious places.
Not quite
I think.
What I was thinking, but that's.
Talk actually, to this guy.
I may not always have the perfect advice for people, but I try to just be here for them. I think that's what they really need more than anything else. Will you see?
I'm waiting for the
wisdom or
another settlement needs your
ear.
Help, Commander. I'm not seeking anything.
Are you sure about that? I think we're all looking for something, even if we're not aware of it. I could be wrong, of course, wouldn't be the first time, but if you find you're desiring something more, perhaps the church can be of service. You might give something of our writings a read. See what you think. I'd recommend starting with Among the Graph Jumps. I'm sure there's a copy lying about somewhere. And if you'd like, we could have a little chat afterwards. I'll certainly be here for it, or any other reason you might need me.
Okay. Sure I did at one point, but I'm drawing a blank.
Understandable. The things I've forgotten over time. Well, you could
do a religious build.
Books. As I said,
we're gonna go full
I'm
Shadowheart.
Sure there's a copy somewhere. My
Where's Char?
Memory. And it would give us an opportunity to discuss the ID. If
All
you
right.
do read it.
So he wants me to find him if I read the book. You guys are all part of
yes,
this?
What? Aquilus has helped me through some tough times lately.
Yeah, okay, that's cool. The Freestar Collective Embassy. Hello, sir.
No loitering. Unless you've got embassy business, I suggest you mosey along.
Damn, okay. You don't even have a freaking front desk person. I would have talked to them. What the hell, man? How's this game? What would you give it out of 10? So, being three hours in or so, I'd probably give the game like an 8-ish so far. Like, it's definitely interesting, and I'm excited to see where it goes. But obviously, that's like 3 hours in, so
the two parties came
don't take it as, you know,
fleet sizes would be capped.
As word for word, or I don't know, I'll take it as like a, I don't know, it's cool, I like it, I'm enjoying it, it's fun, RPGs are cool, it's something new, I like story-based games. The world's ending, what is the last thing you're doing? Doing everything in Baldur's Gate 3. Is there a building or a place to store ships?
Wish that bartender at the
pretty much,
would stop complaining to security. I don't know what she lost, but she won't get it back.
I really like when
us.
You pass civilians, you'll hear like stories. Yeah, talk to the bartender at Viewpoint. That's really cool. Wait, what is this? Oh, that's the bartender. There is base building, yes. There's base building, there's ship building, there's all types of building you can do. I really wanted to sell my stuff. Where is the Mastic District, New Atlantis, Frontier? Where's my ship at? Oh, the Frontier, there it is. I'm gonna fast travel to my ship real fast. And then we're gonna exit ship. Where this guy was telling me where to meet people before.
Shh,
technician.
Hey, kind of breaking my concentration here.
My bad.
Got anything you need to offload? Trade authority is always buying. Kiosk right here for you.
Hey. You know I'm down. Down to sell. All right, let's... What? This said it was worth so much more. Oh, wait. Am I selling right now or am I buying? Sell from ship inventory. Oh, you can put stuff in your ship inventory? What? Ah, shoot. You can sell stuff straight from your ship inventory. It says buy, though, but I want to sell. Right, I'm selling this right now, right? Okay, yeah, we are. Whew. I was like, wait a minute. It's weird because it says Q to buy. So I'm just making sure that I'm not actually buying it myself. Go by value. Suppressed Maelstrom. We'll keep this for now. I really wish you could mark stuff for selling it. Tunnel mining pack, we'll get rid of. Deep mining, we'll keep that. Decorations. Oh, you can also go buy miscellany. Here we go. Sell all, I thought there was a sell all junk. Much better. Wait, if I sell this, do I lose the... I don't lose the bonus, right? I hope not. As weapons, thank you, thank you. Let's get rid of the utility outfit. Jacketed leatherwear. And we also have the Argos extractor jumpsuit. Space suits, we only have one. Okay, yeah, sorting by this is way better. Heavy laser rifle, rare pistol, melee, rifle. Nice. Okay. That's good. Yo, what's up, Dion? Is that DJ Colin? No!
Anything I can help you with?
Wait, where can I find more crew for my ship?
I would try to viewport. It'll be on your left once you get into the plaza.
Okay. The viewport. The lodge. Wait, where is the viewport?
A diplomatic visa? You got to be kidding me.
Hotels and shopping. New Atlantis. Transit. Dude, it's getting dark out here now. Can you play in third person? Okay. Yes. And you can toggle your clothing and stuff too. So that way when you get into like areas that are not required for like wearing outfits and stuff, you can just do that. Or like if you're in a safe area and you don't need to wear your spacesuit, you can toggle it off automatically every time.
It's amazing what passes as art nowadays.
What? This is art? Oh no.
By the My terror, adoring by the fan! Terror, by the terror! I can't believe it! Is it you? Is it really,
it's chat.
Really you?
Look at that! Chat's joining
Captain
us.
Captain of the frontier, bane of the fleet, constellation's shining star of stars.
I just joined Constellation. I'm hardly a shining star.
Oh, you are definitely the brightest, biggest star in any constellation. There's no maybes about it.
Yes, it is.
I have an
He's
eye
back.
For these things. Not that you're hard to see with that halo on your head. Although at first, I wasn't sure if it was just the glare. But now that I know it's you, what are the odds? And to think, I almost went for coffee instead. But I changed my routine for one day, and here you are. It's almost like it was meant to be.
I was just minding my business when you came up to me.
Me too. I was minding your business as well. Visualizing it, dreaming it, and tending to it like a garden in bloom. And now, here it is, our first spring. Either way, it's such an honor to meet you.
Yes, scavenging, hey, concealment, and weightlifting.
Do you mind if I follow you around? Do you need a sidekick? What am I saying? You're a hero. Of course you do. Lead the way.
reject, assign crew. If you're going to... Alright, welcome aboard. Hey, we need them.
You won't be disappointed.
Hey, we need to build our army of people, our companions. Manage your crew. Review and change their assignment between the ships and outposts. Different crew have a different skills when they enhance your ship or outpost. Okay. So, we can assign him to this. And... Oh, that's cool. So you can assign to ship, current outposts, or any outposts. And right now we can only have two on our ship. So he's assigned to Frontier. Crew assign.
Dealing in art is more exciting than one. Selling art is a bit of an art itself, you know.
Do you work around here?
In a sense. No, my trade doesn't necessarily need me to be tied down in one location. Because of that, I travel all over the settled systems. I'm here now for an opportunity.
Is it laggy at the start for you? Not really.
I was in Aquila. Before that,
I get like some frame rate bumps here and there, but it wasn't really laggy.
I can't afford to stay in one place for very long.
We were talking about it, but I couldn't remember his name.
Okay. Back to it then.
Well, I remembered. His name was Curtis.
I am so relieved we have cleared this up.
Hi there.
Hi there.
Thanks for stopping in. Feel free to look around. I can take care of transactions, and if you've got questions, just ask.
What do you have for sale?
Oh, please, take a look.
Check out your wares. Resources? Okay. Oh, whoa. I right-clicked too soon. Too soon there. Employee handbook? They're just selling that? Farming hat? Nice. Get some drip here. Some more drip, that is. Do they have any more settler casual wear? Synth leatherwear? Oh no. Are they back? Helmets? The last guy is the legendary Khajiit. Oh,
thanks,
really?
For shopping at Jemison Mercantile.
Definitely reminds me of Detroit Become Human. I need to go back to Detroit Become Human. It's a game I've been saying I'm going to play at some point.
I'm doing great, actually.
I just
thanks
haven't found the time.
I've got my issues, sure, but my partner's happy.
Okay. What is this? Terabrew Coffee. Where is Viewpoint?
Stock up on the discount stuff. We don't need to.
Can I see, like, where that's at on the map or something? Talk to the bar at view... Oh, it's literally over here. Hey, thank you for the follow there. Okay. Or, oh, we hit the 100 goal follows, or 100 followers goal on TikTok. So thank you guys for that. I really do appreciate all the support tonight.
It's
been a lot of fun so far.
I am a manager.
Nice, they got a bunch of coffee here. Okay.
I should be managing.
GG's. Yeah, thank you.
A spoon recovered from over.
This game is first. You can play in third, too.
Here, one moment. Oh. Gone the next. I tell you, you must cherish it.
Sorry for your loss. Thank I think I'm talking to the guy inside there.
You see, I lost something in that. It was a gem. That scalp.
I think I'm talking to the guy that was sitting inside, but I ran away too fast. Oh, yeah, it's, if you miss it that badly, there has to be a way to get it back.
I agree. I think I know. St. George, like myself, is a collector. Please.
Okay, I'll make the exchange for you.
Fantastic. Here's the plate. Come back. Oh,
Where are my manners? My name is...
All right. Sir, I don't think I was supposed to do that this far away, but all right, that works. Yeah, this I was just talking to this guy. It glitched out. Got the notification about I was doing something. All good. It's pretty fun so far. I've really enjoyed it. There's a lot to do. There's a lot to see. I'm on one planet right now, just running around all the city. So it's been pretty cool seeing like all the, I've gotten tons of quests already, some on this planet, some on other planets. I've really only done like one main story mission, and that was just to get here. So someone said this game is 25 years in the making. Is that true? 25, by that they mean like that they started writing or like thinking of ideas. I think development wise, like actually producing the game, it probably took them, I think it was like less than that. It might have been like 8 years or nine or something. But I don't think it's, I don't think it's like actually been 25 years. Like they started creating the engine for it 25 years ago. Mass Effect better? Mass Effect's a great game too. Let me tell you, you can enjoy Mass Effect, which I absolutely love Mass Effect, and I also like what I've done with this so far. So, quick save and go on a rampage. I would, but chat, tonight, we're going to call it right here. It's getting a little bit late. I usually don't stream this late, but we got access to this, so I wanted to go. We will be back tomorrow night at 6:30 p.m. Eastern. As usual, if I can go live a little bit earlier than that too, I will. And then we'll just make some more progress in Starfield. Saturday, Sunday, Monday, I'm going to be streaming pretty much every day as well. And throughout the day, we'll be swapping. Saturday, we'll most likely start with Starfield. In the afternoon, we'll go into Baldur's Gate. And then probably in the evening, we'll come back to Starfield. So I'm going to be bumping around a lot this weekend, but, we're going to try to make as much progress as we can and see how the game is. We got a lot of stuff to cover. So either way, I'm excited. If you guys enjoyed the stream, make sure you follow. It really does help out a lot. I stream almost every day. All my Let's Plays, everything I do goes up on YouTube. So this one will be up there literally after we hit end stream. If you guys want to watch the beginning, character creation, anything at all, it's all there. But yeah, that's it for me. Thank you all for watching. I'll be back tomorrow, 6:30 p.m. Eastern, or possibly earlier, and we'll take the game from there. So made my character look like Buzz Lightyear. My guy looked like Buzz Lightyear a lot too. But all right, I will see you all tomorrow. Have a good night. And thanks for the follows once again. Peace.